Yeah, I love
Cerebral
it.
satire contains strong language and
Every
thoughts that may
time he
offend.
does
If
that.
you are easily offended, don't fucking bother listening to it.
Happy anniversary! Happy anniversary! Happy anniversary! Happy anniversary! Welcome to Cerebral Satire.
It's not the anniversary show.
I know, we just missed it.
There is 52 weeks in a year.
Yes, but as of last week, October 16th, it is officially the same time that we released. So this should have been on last show, but we weren't paying attention.
But we've never missed a week.
No, we didn't. We've never missed a week. No.
So how have we done a year and we're only up to 50?
I don't know. But
I think your maths is shit. And if there's something I've learned over the last 50 fucking episodes, and it is that your maths is
shit.
Fucking abysmal.
Maths and English.
Well, according to the... I looked it up. October 16th was the official first episode that we broadcasted of Cerebral Satire. And October 16th.
Well, there you
official.
Go.
There's only 50 weeks in a year now.
Evidently.
There you go. Well, obviously we've got the recalled week. And then the release. So, yeah, it sort of makes sense. I can see how it is. But, yeah, well, there you go. It's not only episode 50, it's our anniversary as well. So all tied into one. We're in, like, the twilight zone.
When I found that out, I got a little nostalgia, you know, last
Did
week.
Did you cry? Because you're quite a quiet person, aren't you?
I do get a little sappy. The funny thing is, the most sappy stuff I get sad about is wrestling.
You cry at wrestling
all the time.
Wow, you need to go to a doctor.
Man, I'm watching.
You need to get tested for homosexuality.
When I'm watching Bailey and Sasha go at it, and they're crying at the end of their match, I'm crying.
I literally, and 90% of our listeners don't know who you're talking about.
All right, fine. I'll stop. Well,
who is Bailey?
She is the NXT World
Champion.
Oh,
she's the one that's got Down syndrome.
She does not have Down syndrome. Stop
yes.
saying
I don't watch
that.
Wrestling anymore.
She's
this
got
is
Down syndrome when she goes down on my cock.
She is rather fit.
She's down. Where's the syndrome? Oh, yeah, you've got syndrome.
He's got syndrome.
Definitely.
So, guys, all right. So this is the last episode you're going to hear on the DSJNP feed and the Trending Topics feed. We are now going to our own feed, cerebralsatire.lisbon.com/RS. It is in the notes. If you cannot search for us on your app, take the RSS feed, copy it from your notes, go to enter it manually into your app, and it will pop up immediately.
It's not homework time.
Yeah. That's fucking hell. Are you setting out assignments?
I'm trying to make sure they subscribe.
What you do is you go to iTunes and type in Cerebral Satire.
Cerebral Satire. Now it's on its own. That will pop up and we're all
Well, I'm hoping by the
and
time
if you're
this...
On, and if you're on this, Podcast Republic, do the same.
I'm hoping by
if
the time
If you're on
this,
neither of those, then you don't deserve to listen.
All right. I'm hoping by the time this comes out, iTunes will have accepted our episode because they have yet to do
it. And
that.
If any of you get issues with that, just text us. We'll sort it out immediately.
Yep. You can go to the website. It's cerebralsatire.com. Email us. We'll help you out. Or Twitter, Cerebral Satire. Tweet us. Help you out. Facebook. It's facebook.com. Cerebral Satire. Message us on there. We'll help you out and find it.
So this is an episode of firsts. Isn't it? This is an episode of first because this is their first one on the new feed as well. So we've got to make this show and every show good. Because I'll tell you what, Mr. Vamp, I was going to call you a real name.
This isn't our first
few episodes of this show were pretty shit.
Yeah, they were. This isn't our first episode on the new feed.
Are you putting all the others up here?
Yeah, yeah. We've been broadcasting on the new feed since episode 47, 48.
But the new feed.
You're gonna fuck that up now, aren't you?
Yeah.
Jesus Christ. Just start from 50, man.
No, it's already up. That's already. I'm not gonna take it down. It's already up.
Oh.
So, I'm trying to get the old episodes.
You're confusing one of the bloody hosts.
Well, that's not my fault. That's your fault for not being smart enough on computers. I'm trying to get the other episodes up there. I'm going to try to find out.
That's why I have to go to a little course with 12-year-old children to learn how to do computers.
12-year-old children? Really? 12-year-old children?
I didn't even got up their Excel spreadsheet.
I don't even go to school.
I asked
them. You don't know what an Excel is.
I don't even go to school for my computer class. So I take it online.
What's a cell? And I'm not talking about a prison.
Are you talking to me?
Yeah.
It's the little block on Excel, stupid. Oh, my God.
See, he has got Excel.
He's obviously got Excel.
Wayne, what happened with you this week?
You don't Excel at Excel.
I like Excel the way it used to put 1, 2, 3 down, then you could make it carry on.
I like the way you used to use formulas.
I love Excel.
Can we stop talking about Excel and talk about what happened this week?
That shit's all over Word.
Fucking A, man.
It's better than Sage.
So what happened? What happened this week? What do you guys want to talk about?
I did have loads to talk about as well.
Okay.
I went for a massage. That was fun.
Happy ending?
What? No happy ending.
I've never done that joke.
I bought a Football Manager game, so my life's over pretty much.
That's what you do. You hold the baby and play Football Manager?
Hold the baby and play Football Manager. It's my week off.
There you go.
So I've had this week off looking after baby and stuff. So
is back the new to work one out week. Yet, or was that last year's?
What, the baby?
No, Football Manager.
The new one's out in November, but I bought the old one.
Oh, I can't wait. I've always give it like a 2-year break, Football Manager.
That's why I bought the old one, because usually if when you buy the new one's fucked and it's got loads of
boring.
Fire. All right, move on. I bought a game.
What game?
Football Manager, you prick.
I don't really consider that a game.
That is a game. It's
one of the best-selling games in Britain every year.
It's lame.
Probably one of the best-selling games in Europe, I'd say.
Probably.
Because we like the football. We like football. We kick
we
the balls.
We like to pretend that we're the football.
Like to pretend that we're the football. What else, Ant? Anything else?
There was something I wanted to talk about, but obviously I can't remember. Oh, yeah, fuck it. Yes. Yes, this is what I was going to tell you about. Oh, I've kept it from you as well because I forgot about it. So tomorrow,
yeah.
I'm going, because I joined the Labour Party, right?
A couple of months ago.
I've been invited round to someone's house for a meeting about Labour Party. So I've got my first Labour Party meeting.
Really?
Yeah, tomorrow.
You think
and
it's
I've
be...
got to bring a bottle of wine and stuff.
You think it's going to be full?
So I'm thinking it's like a swingers club.
You think it's going to be full of cunts?
All right. No, I throw all their car keys in the middle.
And find out who's going to fuck each other.
I think it'll be car keys in the middle and let's fuck.
I hope you get some fucking old biddy with like a weak looking hair. Weak looking hair that looks like a wig and she fucking licks her lips when she sees you. Winks.
Yeah, I'd go for it, mate. I'll probably get a bloke.
All right, well, I'm looking forward to hearing about that. See what's going on with your Labour
Party. So I'll tell you about that next week, how it went. But I'm very excited about it.
You sound very excited about it.
I'm very excited about it.
Is Amy going with you?
No, she's not a member.
Oh, hoity-toity.
Definitely.
Wayne, what about you? What's going on this week?
I got Claire into Periscope. She don't do nothing on it. She just looks at what's happening over the world.
She just watches people?
We found a couple of funny things.
Yeah,
she saw a pair of tits. That was the funny one, right? There was this woman writing her like job sort of resignation. The boyfriend was filming it and she didn't realise. So she turns around and goes, "Are you filming me?" He was like, "Maybe." She goes, "Well, why don't you fucking film this? Get the tits out." And then suddenly the feed cuts out. So I don't think he realised that she was going to do that.
I bet Claire loved it.
I bet Claire did love it. How's her lover going? She's
still texting. There's another one now. There's an old woman popped up.
Oh.
And a mazel tov.
Menage.
Oh, mazel tov.
I'm looking for you. Would you like to drink white wine from 30 cup?
Would you
there
like
was another
to,
thing on Periscope. You didn't let me finish out.
Drink it directly from my pee-pee.
Double-ended.
There was... Why are they French?
I don't know.
Because French are liberate. They're liberals.
Yeah, very liberal. Oh, we smoke while we fuck our women. Oh.
Anyway, the other young one on Periscope that we saw was a boy, and he was getting people to when you can put messages on the screen, to put numbers on the screen, phone numbers, and he'd prank them.
You're watching boys live on the internet.
And he kept ringing people up and going, "Hello?" So they'd go on, "Hello?" And he'd go, "Is it me you're looking for?" and just kept singing at him. That was quite funny.
That's not funny at all, actually.
That's funny if you're 10.
Yeah.
And my second question, which still remains from earlier, why are you watching young boys on the internet?
You ready? You ready, Ant? Are you ready? Bring, 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 bring.
Hello.
Hi, is your refrigerator running?
I don't know. Yeah, it's got to be, isn't it?
Well, you better go catch it. Click.
What?
1471. Ring, ring.
Hello?
Ring, ring.
Hello?
I'm going to shoot you in the face, and I'm going to kill one mate. Your mum and dad. You know your mum and dad?
I'm dead!
They're dead.
See? Also, I got freaked out at the toilet at the train station this week.
Why?
Why?
Because I went to do that. That was press taps, you know, when you press them, and then they run for a little bit and turn off. Well, I pressed it, and someone had fucking snotted over the handle, and that was on my hand.
Oh, God's attack. Nice.
I found some porn this week, Wayne, that was all about snotting.
Said.
It was all about people snotting and doing stuff with it.
Why do you watch this shit? I'd love
to. I don't watch it.
I'd love it. Share your internet history with me.
It's in one, I don't save my history. It's in one of those.
It's on there now.
It's in one of those.
Share the screen.
I don't.
Show me the history.
I don't. I can.
I dare you.
I can give you the website.
I'll give you 20 quid if you share your screen and show me your history.
How much? That's like 25 bucks in America, right?
It's fucking 30.
I don't have a history to share.
Yes, because it's fucking full of kiddies and
no,
terrible porn.
No, it's the preview boxes is what you see. You know, as you go down and select your porn, so you're like looking at the preview boxes.
He's only previewing.
What were they doing with the snot? You didn't actually say.
I don't know. I didn't watch it. You want me to send the video to you?
No, you're right.
No.
Can we put it up on the website?
I can imagine what they're doing. They're going. You know,
and probably jerking somebody off with and it or playing with it.
You know,
or...
I've got this thing about art.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
Said it on many shows.
Many shows.
Well, Carl Pilkington's new show, who we love.
Oh, yes.
Did you see the art one?
Yeah, guys. Go check out Facebook.com, Cerebral Satire. I put it up there for everybody to see, Carl Pilkington.
Did you see the actual show?
No, I didn't see it. I didn't see it. Well, I don't think
the actual show is about the show one's about art, and he visits a girl, and all she does is be sick. So she drinks like a funny colored dye, and then she's sick on it. And honestly, I was fucking puking.
I want to see that so bad.
It just confirms all the fucking facts that what I talk about each week on this fucking show about art.
What's that? In case somebody hasn't listened yet, what is that? What is your facts?
Is that a nice pretty picture. Being sick and vaginal knitting is not fucking art. That's my fucking fact.
About art out of driftwood.
Well, it depends what you make out of driftwood. If you make a beautiful little sculpture out of driftwood, you know, something that driftwood could be 600 years old in itself.
That's what my father-in-law does. He puts little wooden seagulls into driftwood, so it looks like a beach.
Yeah, driftwood. Who done that?
Travis.
Travis, there you go. Another
show. Oh, it's on the Science Channel. Sweet, I can get. All right, I'm going to start recording that.
Yeah, watch it. It's really good.
I'm gonna start recording. It's called Moaning.
On the show, but
it's called the Moaning of Life. Moaning of Life.
Yeah,
I can't wait to watch that. Okay, so I went to Florida this week.
Why are you going down there?
Because I had to go down there for like a whole presentation. I had to present in front of a bunch of regional people. And
oh yeah, you did say last week. Yeah,
yeah. Get interviewed.
Is that a man that ignores you? Yeah.
With a man that ignores me?
The bloke that kept ignoring you.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. That cunt. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, come to find out, he'd only been with the company for 2 months. Great. Oh. Yeah.
So he didn't have a clue what he was doing.
Nope, not
a
clue.
He's already more qualified than Van. Says a lot, doesn't it?
Yeah.
He can shrug, which is more than what Van can bring to the table.
Anyway, can I just...
He doesn't
blow
kids.
Can I talk about the airport for a second?
That's an immediate ding.
And I may be talking about the airport in America only. But the amount of liberties that we fucking give away to fly now is fucking insane. And the Atlanta airport is the worst fucking airport I have ever been to in my life. I waited for 45 fucking minutes to get through a security check. Wow. 45 minutes. The line, I'm not kidding. The line was as long as a football field.
That's not
did you
bad.
Get a finger down your cleavage like Morrissey did?
No, nothing happened. Nobody is carrying guns on the plane. No one's carrying knives on the plane. This shit is not happening. How many people have we caught trying to get on the plane again? None! None! Fucking none! Zero!
That's because they're doing the checks.
No, it's not, face. Wayne! No, it's not!
Why isn't it not?
Oh!
It's a deterrent, because they will catch you.
Wayne, there's no sense in me taking off my shoes every time. It's the most, it is the most undignified thing that
undignified.
We give up.
Did you have to get your wiener out?
Wayne, can I ask you a question, right? You know the checks they do?
Yeah.
If they called it the bear checks, right? Have you ever, let's just say bears, they're checking for bears. Have you ever seen a bear on a plane?
No, I ain't never seen a bear on
there
a plane.
There you go.
That's because they do the checks.
Yeah. Exactly. Ugh.
But you've never seen
got
a bear
passport.
On a... Exactly. I'm just
bears
saying.
Bears don't have passports. That's why they do passport
it's
checks
the most...
to stop the bears.
It's yeah,
I'm just saying.
The never imagine seen a bear on a plane. The facade of safety that we project while we give up our liberties is insane to me.
What
it doesn't
you keep
make
talking
any
about
sense.
Liberties. What liberties?
They made
you
take
you
your shoes off by the sound.
No.
At least
certainly.
You weren't blown up in the fucking air.
No,
they
oh
fingered
my
him, Wayne. You know it.
Wayne, the amount of fucking terrorism that happens in the entire world is less than 1% on a fucking airplane. That shit does not fucking happen. I'm sorry,
what,
Wayne.
What are the liberties you keep going on about? What
search and seizure of my person, having to take off my shoes to go to a fucking checkpoint.
I don't think, but I don't think that's a taking away someone's liberty.
It is, Ant. It is 100%.
All right,
we give up our freedom every time we walk through
an airport. When you was driving in your little clown car.
Mazda, motherfucker. It's not a clown car.
Yeah, the wheels.
I don't live in Europe, bitch. I live in America. We have real cars here.
Yeah, unlimited people get out of your car. Like
yeah, he lives in America with real cars, but he drives a foreign car. But anyway, when you was driving on the way to the airport,
yeah,
right,
yeah,
you knew that was going to happen.
Yes.
So why are you pissed about it?
I don't
know it's going to happen.
I'm not. Hang on. I'm not pissed the fact that it did happen. I'm ashamed the fact that as a conscious group of people...
they're not just
checking
for knives. They're checking for drugs and things like that as well, aren't they?
Yeah, people
trafficking.
And people still sneak drugs on the planes all the time.
Yeah, but you're making it like it's just a terrorism thing. But there's trafficking. There's loads of different crimes that
no one is trafficking. No one is trafficking drugs from Atlanta to Florida. That's like taking sand from Atlanta to Florida. You don't do that. There's more drugs in Florida than there is in Atlanta. We've done.
That's not what they do. That's how they do trafficking. They go via routes like that. So they'll go from. Like fucking, they'll start in Vietnam and then they'll go to Russia and then from Russia
not,
to like Holland
no,
and then they'll do
the
like
border.
Internal flights.
There was no crossing the border here.
I know, but you know what I'm saying. That's what they do that. They don't just do a direct flight. Boom,
okay.
That's traffic.
And
they go.
I'm also not well. Talking about your airports. From what I hear, your airports are a lot more dignified than mine.
No, they're exactly the same.
No, they're not.
They're exactly the same.
I know from a fact they're not exactly the same. I know for a fact that they're not exactly
fact.
The same.
How do you know for
because
a fact?
I've heard people talk. I've heard people compare the airports in America to the airports in Europe or Britain or Germany. I've heard people compare them. Literally, leave from America and go to Europe and compare the two, and they are you are treated like an adult in Europe. You don't have to take off your shoes.
Yes, you do.
That's not what I've heard.
Well, you think I don't travel? How many countries?
No. I'm not saying you don't travel. I'm just saying that's not what I heard. That's all I'm saying.
You do. It depends if you get stopped.
Okay.
I can
well,
get
no.
my whole bag ripped apart.
Yes, you can. But if you're not stopped, I didn't get stopped. This is
no,
what I have to do.
No, everyone's get stopped. I mean, if you get pulled aside. They've pulled me aside before.
Yeah, that's fine. That's a check. That's fine. I get that. If you get pulled
taking
aside.
Shoes off, no, like, that's a big one.
Every time, everybody has to take their shoes off. Old ladies that are 70 years old.
And your belt.
Yes.
Yeah.
It's
I just don't understand why someone's so angry over security check.
I know. They're trying to help you.
No, they're not.
They're just trying to help
you. No, they're not. They're fucking imbeciles. We gave power to a bunch
help
of retards.
Them to help you.
We gave power to a bunch of retards. We're help paying these them. People $15 an hour. They barely have a high school education. They don't know what the fuck they're doing. They don't know what they're doing.
No, that's not fair. On the
it is fair. It's completely fair.
That's not fair on people just trying to do a hard day's work, mate.
They're
come
not
on.
Trying to... Whatever. All
right. Come on. Not, you're being anyway, nasty to them people.
I will say this. I will say this. The Orlando airport was awesome. I didn't have to take my shoes off.
Did they take shoes off?
No, I didn't have to take my shoes off. Didn't have to take my shoes off.
But you just said all of your airports got to do that.
I didn't say all
Europe.
My airports.
Now you've just
the Atlanta it. Airport. I have to. It's fucking ridiculous. It's just I was so irritated going through there.
I can tell.
That
why
my
are
head
you
was
so
going
angry
to
about heaven security when I got snot on my hand in a train station toilet? I should be the one shouting.
Yes, yeah. Yes, absolutely.
All you have to do, Vam, is put your fucking headphones on, listen to one of the archive episodes of Cerebral Satire, which you can find on the Cerebral Satire feed on iTunes and other
places. Take that finger
places.
Like a good boy.
You can take that 45-minute wait, listening, having fun. Listening to us have a giggle and you can giggle along with us.
I did. I tried.
And then
I couldn't
just
do
take
it
your fucking shoes off and you could throw one of their shoes on. like they did at Mr. Bush. But,
all right. Yeah. I just real quick. If the listeners think that I'm crazy, please go to Cerebral Satire Twitter and say hashtag DV crazy or hashtag vamp crazy, whichever one you want. Just say vamp is crazy. Fuck you.
That's blatantly one now.
Fuck you.
He's just made it.
Fuck you, Wayne. Or you can say Anton Wayne is right. Either one. Tell me. Right. I want to know literally as soon as I can figure out how to do a poll, we're going to start doing polls on stuff. But I want to know if I'm crazy or not. I want to know.
You're crazy, mate.
I'm not crazy.
Just chill out.
It's
take your shoes off.
My constitution rights are being taken away
plane?
From me.
You wouldn't have been too happy then, would you?
I didn't, Wayne. You're not. That's not
you
what we're talking about.
Yeah, you didn't have an incident because they did the check.
That is so
there.
Fucking. That is the most
point
ridiculous.
Proved.
That is the most ridiculous. Wayne. Hang on. Wayne, are you talking you'll give up every right you've ever had? Every right you've ever had.
Every right you've ever had.
Wait a minute. No, I'm asking you a question. I'm asking you a question, Wayne. Will you give up every right you've ever had to have security to make sure nothing ever bad happens to you?
If I was just taking my shoes off, yeah.
No, I'm not asking you that. Will you give up every right you've ever had to be 100% assured that nothing ever bad happens to you?
That's
I think you're taking
question.
It ever so far.
I'm not. I'm really not.
That's such a broad spectrum.
It's not. Hell? It's not. To me, it's not. It's not.
Well,
it's
your
a,
shoes
it's
is
an,
everything you've ever worn.
We've had incidences.
The meaning of life is your shoes.
We've had incidences.
Maybe since
this has gone on. And it's just it's a facade. It's a facade, and it's a facade and an excuse to search every citizen that takes a flight. That's exactly what it is. It's ridiculous.
This is my little final sentence on it.
I'm so glad I don't fly. I'm so fucking glad I don't fly.
Right. This is my thing on it. Maybe because the whole taking the shoes off thing at an airport is regarded to terrorism. We all think that terrorists are fucking Muslims and stuff like that. But at mosques, you have to take your shoes off, don't you? So maybe it's all connected.
All right, let's go into quickfire.
Pew, 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 pew.
Quickfire. I like that. It's good. It's good stuff right there.
What's with the quickfire?
I don't know. I always thought should be quickfire. Woman sues 12-year-old nephew over a hug that broke her wrist. Aunt, this chick's a cunt, you said?
Yeah, I cannot. I've got no other words for this horrific human being. So the kid hugs her. The kid was 8.
Yep. 12-year-old, she sued. Woman at court in Connecticut has rejected a woman's claims for $127,000 in damages after she tried to sue her 12-year-old nephew for jumping into her arms at his own 4-year-old birthday party.
No, he was 8.
Oh, it's his birthday party 4 years ago. Sorry.
Yeah, it's 4 years ago. He was 8. He hugged his auntie. He sort of jumped into her arms. She fell over, broke her wrist, and she's suing her own nephew. Now, if that's not case for an absolute human piece of shit, I don't know what is. Either that or her bones are like fucking Skeletor.
out, get you. Sean Tolero was just 8 when he leapt into his Aunt Jennifer's arms. 54-year-old human resources sought damages on a relative ground. She should have been more careful. We do not take great pleasure in bringing a minor to court. She is not here enjoying a moment of this, said Conley's lawyer, who is a cretin. But Sean should have known better. We have rules for children. He was not careful. He was unsafe. The jury took only 25 minutes to find against Miss Conley, a human resource manager who works in New York. We just couldn't find him, you know, liable for what happened, one female juror. So this woman has become the poster child of horrible, horrible family members. How does that, you guys think that ruins the family dinner at Christmas
it's
dinner?
It's not going to build morale, is it?
I'm telling you. That's
pass me the
really
pudding
bad.
And the lawsuit, please.
Yeah.
And again, it goes back to America's sue culture.
Oh my God, yes. We love to sue people.
Ambulance
for no
chases.
Reason.
This wouldn't even be a thing in Britain.
Yeah, because what the laws, what there is.
You can do it.
If you lose.
It's just common sense. They'd laugh at you if you tried putting
that. They'd laugh at you if you wanted to sue someone over that. That is ridiculous. It's not even breaking the law.
It's ridiculous.
Our lawyers only take cases on when they know they're going to win. And you look at that case, no one thinks they're going
to
win.
I mean, the only thing you could take it to here would be a small claims court, and that'll just get laughed out
by
a judge. So, it's nonsense.
Japan citizens stockpile toilet rolls. Do you guys know about this? You guys know about this? Sales of toilet paper in Japan have increased by 500 million rolls since 2008, despite a steady decline in the country's population the same period.
Well, I think it's because...
it's insane.
Do you reckon they buy the rolls in spring? Because they love spring rolls.
Devil.
Shit, yeah. Wrong country.
Yes.
Devil.
Yes.
Devil.
Yes. Child. Like my little niece, devil. Yes.
You've got a joke coming. It's a joke then.
Yeah, it better
be
a joke.
Go on.
What hand do you use to wipe your bum with?
Right.
I use paper, you sick fuck.
According to one of Japan's...
That is possibly the worst joke we've done on this show.
Why is toilet paper use going up when numbers of people supposedly going down? The paper asks, pointing to the aftermath 2011 earthquake, toilet paper disappeared from the shelves of shops. The answer is temporary storage.
Stockpiling.
Yeah, they're stockpiling it because of earthquakes. Another factor introduced in luxury products, a Dayo Paper Corp says, 2 and 3 ply rolls are only half the length, leading to people simply buying more, they say.
Yeah.
My brother said he could use one sheet of paper to wipe his ass with. I'm sorry, I have to wrap it around my hand twice before I can use it.
Really?
Yep.
You sounded exactly like him.
What? Hang on. I was reading something. Okay. Say that again.
My brother said, right.
My brother said. That's what retards say. You know that.
He's only got a small hole and he needs one sheet of paper. I need to wrap like the paper around my hand a couple of times, then pull it off, and then you use that, you know?
Why do you wrap it? Why are you wrapping paper around your hand like a bandage?
Because he's 4. Because he's fucking 4. That's why.
Why is it wrapping it around like a bandage?
Because he's 4.
I don't want to get put on my hand.
That's because he's 4. See?
But you finger your ass in the bath.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but that's in the bath.
So why can't you get poo on your hand and then wash your hand? No comeback.
Silence.
8 minute silence. 8 minute silence.
Silence.
That's the longest silence we've ever had. That was 8 minutes. Answer, please.
I don't wipe my ass with it wrapped around my hand. It's just the gauge of like a measuring tool.
How many toilet paper
rolls? Around the hand and then slide it off and use that.
How many toilet paper rolls do you go through a month?
My mum says that she saved a lot of money ketchup and toilet roll since I've moved out.
Not surprised. You know, you unroll like 3 or 4 squares. You wrap the 3 or 4 squares up.
They used to have
value
toilet roll. Now they have like Andrex.
Be a big fan of Blue Peter by the sounds of it.
Right now I'm doing 2-ply because I bought the wrong type of roll, so I'm having to like use like 3 or 4.
I have to have very soft squares. very
all
soft.
All we have is 2-ply. You have to pay
what's
a lot
2-ply?
For that.
I don't know what this 2-ply is.
You know,
just
toilet roll, Ant, when you pull it wrong,
I do.
It goes in the 2 thin bits, don't it? That's the plies, 2 plies.
What? Say that again.
See, most of our toilet roll is 2-ply unless you pay premium prices and go up to 3.
Well, I might be a 3-er.
I think you're a 3-er, Ant. If you don't know...
Go and check your toilet roll, Ant. I bet you're 2-ply.
Wayne, stop
yelling.
I don't
know what I'm looking for, do I?
Ant, if you don't know what 2-ply is, you've never had to deal with 2-ply.
It's our standard, devil.
I understand that, Wayne.
I understand that.
I understand that.
I do buy very expensive toilet rolls.
When you rip the toilet roll and the plies go out of sync,
yeah.
So then you've got like two different lengths.
What do you wipe with at work? It must be shitty toilet paper. It has to be really shitty toilet
paper.
Yeah,
I'd imagine just normal British toilet paper.
Yeah, so it's probably two-ply.
Right, okay.
So then at home,
I don't know.
Ply is the layers of toilet roll. You know how toilet roll can go into like separate bits.
He is set on explaining this to you.
There's just one thing I know that I don't, so I've got to share
so
my
it's
knowledge.
Like the thickness of it.
Yes, that's exactly okay. Right, yes.
So could you get like an 8-ply?
God, that'd be
lucky. What does the ply mean? What does the ply mean?
The softness.
Ply is the layer. So it's two ply, it's two layers.
What does
layers.
Ply mean?
The softness, it equals to how soft it is.
But
normally.
I've never heard that ply.
It's normally on the
packet of your fucking toilet roll. Wayne.
Is it a made up word or something?
No, it's on the fucking packet. He's mugging me off.
I'm saying is it a made-up word that, like, just toilet manufacturers have made up?
Wayne, calm down. It is a standardized use around the world.
You tell me to fucking calm down after your shoe rack.
It is a standardized use around the world to compare softness of toilet paper.
Right, okay.
Ant is a retard. How sleeping?
I'm not a retard. I just don't know a lot about shitty paper. I should know more about things that matter.
He just walks into Tesco and goes, that will do.
I pick it up and go, that will do. I wipe my ass. I'm not looking at the back of it like a fucking ingredients. I'm getting my daily nutrition out of my shit paper.
Just like sleeping on a bed is important, which we're trying to pass that on to Amy so you can get a bigger bed. Wiping your butt is pretty important. You'll get piles really quick.
I do get piles.
Maybe it's time to switch your paper, buddy.
How does sitting on wet grass give you piles?
I don't know. How sleeping with my female school teacher almost killed me is from Vice.com. So evidently, there's a 20-year-old woman who had sex with an 11-year-old boy she was babysitting. Burn. Received a suspended prison sentence after the boy's father said he was sex mad and fully up for the experience. This is from the UK.
We've done this. I mean,
but
it's... If that you know that dad's banged her. You know that dad's banged her. Arrow was the dad.
Actually, that's correct. The dad has banged her.
Boom.
The dad banged her and then sent her in the room to bang his boy.
Boom.
Yep.
What did the teacher have to ply him with? To ply?
Have to ply him? Wow. I like what you're trying to do with like the segue and stuff, but it's not work, mate.
Two ply. That worked at all. Shit.
You see what I did? Because shit's toilets and stuff. We've done toilets in the next one.
Two ply.
People who talk to themselves aren't crazy. They're geniuses.
To ply or not to ply. That is the question.
I talk to myself on the bus.
How often do you talk to yourself on the bus?
Every time I'm alone.
He's either talking to himself on the bus or he's licking the fucking windows. It's one of the two.
No, honestly, I do.
I know you do.
For correct answers.
I talk to myself too.
It's just a way to sort out your head, isn't it? It clears it. You talk it over with yourself and you ain't got to fucking burden anyone else with it.
No, I don't do
Why
that.
Why can't you just
internally do it?
Just do it like in your brain.
No, I literally sort of mumble it. I actually mumble it. I don't speak it. I mumble. What? And I actually like go through like, oh, that'd be quiet on the next one. That'd be all right. And then I'll be like going home and that'd be fine.
Do you use different voices?
I'm gonna take a lot of crap for this right now. Here we go. I caught myself DV and I talked to myself.
I don't talk cunt. Like a thingy. I sort of just have cunt. I talk with an inner monologue sort of talk to myself. I don't actually converse.
You haven't got different characters. Like,
hello, DV. Oh, I'm fine, Derek.
That's not good. If you have different voices, that's not good. That's multiple personality disorder.
And you go like, what do you think about it, Waynetta? Oh, I think it's fantastic. And then like someone's trying to buy a fucking ticket for the bus.
Albert Einstein talked to himself.
Yeah, but he was a prick. He was German.
So?
Well, he's German.
Talking to yourself, it helps you achieve your goals.
Oh, that reminds me. My car was one of the affected cars in the emissions scandal.
Ooh.
I got a letter this week, yeah.
Your VW?
My Seat. There was only 7,000 diesels in the UK that were affected, and mine's one of them.
So you got to go get a new car?
Nope, they said that they ain't worked out what they're going to do yet. I can actually go and get the letter. It says they ain't worked out, so sit tight. They'll write to me again when they get the service plan ready. So
okay. Watch Furious Driver mow down pals.
Where that come from?
I don't know where that
came
from. That
just came really out of left field, Wayne. You just come out with that. Yeah. Like,
mows down his pals who teased him about his pink jumper.
Did Waynetta tell you to say that?
I don't know why he did that. I don't know why he did that.
Did like she prompt you? Just like, oh, tell him
about
this.
Do you know dentistry? Dentists. This is an actual fact. They've done a survey.
This is Waynetta again. This is Waynetta.
When did this become satire,
Wayne?
It's an
actual survey. Dentists have the higher suicide rate than any other profession.
Yes, we did. I did know that. Mm-hmm. That's a common fact.
And can we move on, please?
Yeah, I never stopped you.
Watch if you...
That was Waynetta. So thanks for stopping by, Waynetta.
Thanks, Waynetta. Watch and, furious driver mow down pals who teased him about a pink jumper. Wayne, you gave us this one. An angry driver who was laughed over at his pink jumper and a pink bag tried to get revenge by driving into several people smoking outside the venue.
I bought a tank top, you know, like jumpers without
the sleeves.
You bought
a tank top?
The jumpers with the out the sleeves.
What a wife beater?
What sort of cunt wears a tank top?
No, I don't know what it's called. What are those jumpers without the sleeves?
Tank top!
A sleeveless shirt?
It's a tank top!
And a jumper. Woolly
yeah,
jumper.
It's a tank top!
Okay, Wayne, right. Tell the story.
It's pink because I was trying because I saw Brian Molko.
You brought
Placebo
a pink
in,
tank top.
But I bought it and it was a size too small. So then I wore it on a night out because I thought, fuck it, I spent money on this. I wore it out and I looked like a fat little pink thing.
Why would you?
He looked like a little pink.
Firstly, pink. A tank top's cool, and secondly, a pink one.
Brian Molko was wearing one.
Who the fuck's he?
Placebo.
Friend in need's a friend indeed, but I'm a fucking emo.
And he looked good in it, but I didn't.
That's a good song, first of all.
Great song.
Of Wayne, course he looked good. Wayne.
Pink tank top. Yes. You want to look like me, but you will just look like a fucking really geeky.
I wish I knew what you're going to say so I can just echo you. I really do. A friend in me.
You just sound like a fucking 40s movie person. That's crazy.
Ed, do you have any pink shirts?
I had. Well, I've got one for work, which is quite smart, though. Mm-hmm. You know, it's like a proper...
Buttoned up.
Yeah, it's not overly pink as well. It's just, you know...
They call it...
Like
what proper, they call that?
Proper suits.
What is what's Triple H call salmon. That? Salmon.
Not pink, it's salmon.
Salmon.
But no, it's
not
like
as violent, you Nimrod.
You Nimrod. I have one, too. I have a pink shirt that goes with my suit.
Wayne, I've got a little joke for you, mate. Vamp won't get it.
Okay.
It's not my tank top.
What's pink and hasn't moved in over 8 years?
His wife.
My wife's vagina.
Madeline McCann slippers.
Oh, my God.
All right, we're going to go straight into our new segment here, guys. I don't know what the fuck they're talking about. More British humor that doesn't make any sense. Here we go. Let's move into our new segment.
It's the shitty corner. It's the shitty corner. It's the shitty corner. It's the shitty corner.
Fucking wrong.
Well, we got our new theme song. All right, Ant, we got some shit news this week, man.
Great.
Which we do every week, but we just realized we do it every week, so now we made it a segment. Man suffers from constipation for 10 years and has an 11-pound stool removed. Now, you said this was bullshit. So
I don't know, man. Yeah. I'm not sure about this one.
It's on foxnews.com, man.
Oh, it's got to be fucking true, then.
I know. That's what I'm saying. They're the leader in truth.
It basically says that this is about a 27-year-old who was suffering from severe constipation for 10 years, and he underwent surgery to get the shit out of his ass. But like, they've done a series of x-rays, and they revealed that the patient's heart had shifted to the right.
His heart?
Because his ass had swelled twice the size.
Oh, my God.
Because he was that constipated, it actually moved his heart.
So in other words, he backed up through his entire colon and his entire intestines.
The whole system
was backed up into his stomach, and his stomach got so bloated it moved his heart.
Like, I mean, you know when you have a brilliant shit and it's like it's painful, but then once it goes, whoop,
it feels so good.
It feels so good. Can you imagine how good that felt?
Oh man, I can just
holy fuck! I've done an amazing shit. Listeners, I am quite partial to sending these two pictures of my poo. I actually sent you a picture of my baby's poo the other day.
Oh, my God. That was the most disgusting thing I've ever seen in my life. I've seen people's head blown off. I've seen people get stabbed. I've seen people get hit by trains. I was one of those people. I was one of those people that bought those Seven Faces of Death videos or rented them and watched them at home because I thought that shit was fucking cool back then. Now it gives me nightmares. But that picture of the first poop that your baby had was the most disgusting black tar lung thing I have ever seen in my entire life.
It's good. And you can catch it on cerebralsatire.com.
Yep, we'll put it online. We'll put it on cerebralsatire.com and you can see for yourself.
So gross. Oh, it's so... Just imagine the... Oh, oh.
11-pound shit.
11-pound shit,
that's, that's like a really heavy baby.
They diagnosed him with congenital megacolon, which calls paralysis.
Megacolon. That sounds like a fucking Transformer.
That sounds like fucking good thing to have. I've got a megacolon.
People of the Earth, are you ready to rumble with megacolon?
I'm megacolon.
My weapon is big poo.
Nice job, Wayne. Which can cause paralysis of the movement of the bowels and can sometimes lead to fecal tumors. Surgeons later removed an 11-pound stool that had lodged itself in the patient's colon and caused severe pain. He is currently in recovery, CEN reported. So,
have you ever gone for a poo and it's hurt so much as it's coming out and it gets stuck that you have to shit, so just sit there and shake in pain?
No. Yes. No.
Yeah, of course I did. I done one the other week, actually.
Did you really?
It's the most heart-stopping thing. My heart races when it happens, when it just is so big and it hurts and you can't do nothing. You can't get it out. It's just hurting and it feels like, I don't know. And you sit there and you just shake and you're like, oh!
Boom Beam City.
Damn it.
Of sex.
Well done.
Sorry.
He's looking at fucking god porn.
No,
again,
it's that's it's uprocks.com decided to put a nice video on.
Ruined my poo story.
Yeah. Well, there's another one. This woman walked into a UFC fighter's home, pulled down her pants, and pooped everywhere. So we just saw a woman knock on the door, open the door, walk into my house, not saying anything, lock herself in my bathroom. Well, that sounds like an interesting night. That quotes come from Yura Faber, who posted the story via Snapchat over the weekend. The possible drunk woman proceeded to vomit and defecate all over the UFC fighter's bathroom before she was removed by Sacramento police. Some brave soul captured all of Faber's snaps and compiled them into one very poopy video. This is not safe for the work, but Wayne will put it on the website, dshnp.com.
He's a little dude, isn't he?
Yeah, he's little, but he's fucking built like a shit fucking brick house, man.
He's quite a small little guy, though.
So here, I'm going to play the video. You guys can listen to it, and we're going to watch it at the same time. So here's the video. This is all the Snapchats that he put together.
Woman knock on the door, open the door, and walk in my house, not say anything, and lock herself in my bathroom.
He's got a nice house. So he's walking. He's walking to the bathroom right now. It's very dark. Uber, turn a fucking light on.
Here we are.
So the police are there right now.
Yeah.
Can you imagine? Wait, can you imagine somebody walking into your house, Ant? Walk into your bathroom and then just shitting on it?
Well, it's obviously he was having a party or something going on.
He looked like he had a couple friends over.
He had multiple people in his house.
Well, he looked like he had a couple friends over.
Yeah.
It would be like...
You got shit, mate. You got shit. She could have not. Right, this is. She was obviously drunk. She's passed out, as we'll find out. But you know, you could knock on the door like, "Oh, I want to come in, please let me. I need to shit." You know.
Yeah. Why don't you just ask? And why would you let somebody? I would not let somebody in my house. Even
just do it on your fucking porch, then you can.
That's fine. That's fine. Do it on my porch.
Do it on your porch.
Still call it police.
If you don't let me in your house, I'm gonna shit everywhere. Post it through your letterbox.
The text is on the case.
The idea. That someone walks into my house and then just shits all over it. Oh my God, she's naked, passed out on the floor.
I've shat on the floor in someone else's house.
You have not.
Yeah, and then I dated her for like 8 months afterwards.
Are you lying right now?
No, that is not a lie. That's a genuine truth.
What's her name then? Just give her first name.
Amy. It's the one that used to...
Oh, the other Amy.
Yeah, the mental one. And yeah, so...
Is that when you first met her?
What? Yeah, so I went... Well, I was drum and bass MC then, so she came to one of my gigs.
Okay.
And I knew her sort of through some mates anyway. Uh-huh. And then I went back to her place and we were smashing out the drink. I was drinking loads of different stuff like vodka and that. Yeah. And I was like, right, I need a shit. I'm going to go upstairs. And I went up and I obviously passed out on the shitter whilst having a shit. But obviously slipped off the toilet. And I didn't know that I thought I'd finished and just fell asleep on the toilet. But like a couple of months later, she was like, nah, there was shit all up your ass and everything. I was like, what? And you didn't like fucking just kick me out? Oh, she was like, nah. And then the next morning.
No, I licked your ass.
I must have been like wasted. Had all shit up my ass. She's wiped my ass, flipped in the toilet and that.
What?
I've woke up. I've gone into the room. So I've not cleaned my teeth. I've still got sick everywhere all down me.
You woke
and
up.
And then I went in there and fucked her.
What?
Yeah.
Right then you should have realized you shouldn't be with that girl. Right then you should be like, this is not for me. If this girl was willing to fuck me while I have puke on me and I smell like shit, she is not worth keeping around for a while. She must be insane.
She was insane.
Wayne, you've been quiet.
I've got no funny stories of Claire shitting.
I bet you've got some funny stories.
Well, she shat at work and I had to take her home, but other than that.
Why? Why'd you have to take her home?
She was ill. She shat on the shop floor.
She shat on the floor in the
store. Yeah. She was really ill. The antibiotics was affecting her.
Did
stomach.
She have like a skirt
she
on
had,
or something?
No, she had trousers.
So she
shat her pants.
She undid her trousers?
No, she shat herself.
Oh, but
she had a bad
your
mouth.
Family,
so she was,
what's with your family and shitting in supermarkets? Because didn't her dad shit himself in Morrison's?
Yeah, that's true. Actually, I didn't even put it together. Well, I was in the bakery, and the manager Sue Knight's come up to me and go, "I think you need to come
Sue
with me."
Sue Knight.
And I was just like, "Right." And then she took me into the women's toilet, which was weird. And there was Claire crying. I was like, "What's wrong?" She was just like, "Can I go home?"
Oh no, she didn't let her any motor.
Why would you?
That's where I was clever. I took some clear plastic bin bags.
You're a piece of fucking shit. Let me tell you how big of a piece of fucking shit you are. You motherfucker.
You're getting
him off, huh?
You
fucking bitch.
You know he said that as well.
I know.
You're getting my fucking girl.
You could just stand right there and we'll get some fucking plastic bags. You are such a dickhead to your wife. Oh my
Why?
God. Because she's sick. She doesn't want to stand outside your car that's while
when,
you're fucking.
That's when, like, there's a phrase, Wayne. Be sincere.
Yes. Be
I was,
kind.
I took her home.
And, yeah, wrapped in plastic.
After putting bin bags down. You can get my fucking girl.
My car's dirty.
Yeah.
There we go.
This really fucking happened.
So there's fire. Now there's fire and rescue Did because this chick passed out.
Big girl as well, isn't she?
Oh, man. Big lady.
Have you been here before?
Faber, turn some fucking lights on, man.
Why are you telling him? He's like.
Oh yeah,
it's past tense, man.
He's not gonna.
Oh my god.
What's your name?
What's going on?
She doesn't even know her name.
Well, she's drunk.
She's out.
Strung
oh my asshole. Goodness. Holy crap! That place is covered in poop and throw up.
Poop.
She didn't even know her name when the paramedics walked her outside. Didn't even know her name. She did exactly what you did, Aunt. She was on the toilet. She fell out the toilet
off
with
it.
Their asshole showing.
That was think of that as me.
This is you, totally you, dude.
In someone else's house.
Woman shits herself. Burglar woman shits herself. Pukes everywhere.
Sacramento Heroes, yeah, that's good. So, I have never done that. Now, I have puked in a potted plant at the airport, and I have, my dad found me, the first time I ever drank heavily at my uncle's wedding, my dad found me on the toilet, naked, passed out, because I had shit myself on the wall.
Because you've been raped.
I made it to, I made it to a toilet. So, so that's our poop segment, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. Let's move on to
I just want
to
say, quickly, you know when you say, like, poop?
You don't like that? You don't like that poop?
No, I don't. I don't mind the word poop. I prefer shit or feces.
Or
I like feces.
You like feces?
I do like feces.
Excrement.
But, yeah, that's okay as well. Mm. But when you say poop, it's like your mouth sort of does a arsehole shape, doesn't it?
Yeah, like poop. Like
it's quite an apt word
like
for what it is.
Like Mr. Bean. how he makes those funny faces by saying the most generic words. Poop.
Mr. Bean's a gun.
Let's move into the next story. So before we get into Wayne's facts, this is my question, guys. I'm probably going to be moving soon. I have a lot of DVDs that I haven't watched since I literally have moved into this place 4 years ago.
Okay.
I don't want to move all this shit again.
Is it like Indiana Jones and the Temple of Womb?
No. I have all three Lethal Weapons. I'm looking at them right now.
Get rid of them.
Like almost all the Ocean's Elevens, a lot of Disney movies I don't watch anymore.
The wrestling stuff I do watch. You don't need it.
Yeah, I mean, I have the Star Trek seasons, but I mean,
right. Are you on about ditching them?
Yeah, I think I'm going to trade them in.
Here's the perfect thing to do. And okay. This is what I've done before many years ago. What I did was all your special edition DVDs. Mm-hmm. I have got a couple. Mm-hmm. I keep them. And then everything that I want other than that, I burn onto the computer or onto this little fucking
make digital,
USB sticks
like a portable hard drive.
Yeah, just like a portable hard drive.
It's not a bad
idea. And then everything else, just fucking get rid of it. Charity shop, whatever.
Well, I do have a shop here called Movie Stop, and they'll trade in DVDs, and you get in store credit or cash. And
just give it to the fucking homeless.
Why?
Just give it to a fucking halfway house or something.
No.
That's a proper like no.
No, they're mine. No, they're mine. I bought them.
But just give them away. But you
he wants
said
his credit back because he's a tight fist.
But you want to get rid of them, though. You don't want to take them with you.
No, I want to get rid of them. But
he helps British Heart Foundation out. No, he just want to help his fucking back pocket back out.
Exactly.
Oh, man.
No, I want to trade them back in, and I want to get more Blu-rays because I do watch the Blu-rays I have. I do watch. Like I have 10 Blu-rays right now, and I do watch them. I watch them probably on a regular basis. Like I have Star Trek, Firefly, Paul Heyman. Oh, that's Paul, the movie, Star Trek Into Darkness, Fight Club, Kick-Ass, The Last Samurai, a good amount of stuff. But like a lot of these movies I haven't touched since I moved. They were good movies. V for Vendetta's down here. Any Given Sunday, Pulp Fiction.
Do you know what that's doing?
Austin Powers of Spy.
Do you know what that's doing?
What?
That's feeding your own neuroses. That's I've got DVDs that I ain't touched. And do you know why I've got them?
Why?
If someone comes around my house and looks at my DVD collection, they'll go, oh, you've got that movie.
It
oh,
is,
that's a good
isn't
movie.
It is, right?
And it's your own neuroses. It's your it own is. Fucking bullshit neuroses. Just get rid of it. If you ain't fucking watched it in what I think if you ain't watched it in 2 years, that's a good game to get
yeah,
out.
Yeah, I agree. I agree. So, I agree. I'm going to have to get rid of all of them then.
Get rid of them, mate.
Plus, I want to trade some of them up to get Blu-rays.
Just give them a charity.
Yeah, I'm going to get rid of them. All right, let's move into Wayne's Facts. Here we go. Everybody ready? It's time to
teach Wayne.
Okay, Wayne?
Yeah?
Yes?
He
in 19... What?
What? You said what?
Pardon. It's pardon, isn't it?
Yeah, anyway, keep going.
In 1970s, people in Cambodia were killed for being academics or merely for just wearing glasses.
Did you know that men can read smaller print than women, but women can hear better?
But what about my fact? I'm teaching you.
But they're
and
angry.
Yes, I did know. I did know about that.
I knew that too, actually.
But they're angry in Cambodia. Cambodia.
Are they what?
They're angry, aren't they?
They are. Oh, they were back then in the Pol Pot days.
So,
yeah.
Nice job, Wayne.
Know a lot about Pol Pot.
Nice job, Wayne.
Not really. That's why I'm not commenting.
There you go. Educate yourself.
He killed a lot of people, Wayne. A lot of people.
Oh, I know that much.
Oh, all right. Well, there you go.
I'm Wayne. Not totally stupid.
Wayne.
What?
Wayne.
What?
Yes, Daddy. It's not what. Chrysippus, an ancient Athenian philosopher, died from laughter.
STD?
That's pretty good joke. I'll give you that one. Chrysippus, not syphilis, an ancient Athenian philosopher, died from laughing at one of his own jokes.
Is that Athenian? Is that a type of bug in an aphid?
It means he comes from Athens.
Oh, right. That just sounded like aphid.
So it's an Athenian, I believe.
Aphids are insects, buddy.
Yeah. Bug. That's what I said.
I apologize. I thought
you insects
said
or bugs.
I thought you said bird. I apologize.
Not everything's a fucking bird.
I thought you... I have said I apologize. Calm down.
What do you think of the fat Wayne?
Yes, Wayne.
What did he do in Greece?
For fuck's sake.
The word typewriter is the longest word in the English language that can be spelt at the top of the keyboard.
It's episode 50, Andy. I don't know why you thought this was going to go any other way.
Elephants purr like cats do as
Wayne,
a means of communication.
Wayne, what? If you want to do your own facts, we can make a segment. Don't interrupt Ant in his facts. It confuses the listener.
They know like He's... me.
Wayne.
You sound like you're annoyed.
What do you think of the man that died from laughing at one of his own jokes?
Did he have a weak heart?
More than likely.
I think eventually Ant's going to die of laughing at his own jokes because he really thinks he's funny.
I am fucking funny. What are you on about?
Don't
you're my
laugh,
biggest. You're my biggest fan.
I was going to say, you fucking know all you do is giggle at him.
You're my biggest fan. That's why I do this fucking show.
Because he's funny.
You feed my neuroses.
Because he makes me laugh. That's why.
Wayne don't laugh at
he's
no
funny.
One.
He doesn't laugh at anything you say.
Am I supposed
you
to?
Are you fucking dumb? Am I supposed to?
I'm supposed to.
I'm moving on. Wayne.
Yeah?
Fucking fat sausage roll eating twat.
He's angry. He's still passive aggressive.
I don't think that was passive aggressive. I think that was just blatant aggressive.
He cut you off again.
Wayne, a red telephone box which was brought for £1 has been turned into a village library in England. People can go to a book, but go and take a book and swap it for one they like if they want to. What do you think about a red telephone box?
Is that Fornham? Near me on my bus route, because there is a red phone box with books in.
Well, it could be then.
It could be then.
That's on my bus route going to Gislingham.
I think that's pretty.
Gislingham. That's a.
I think that's.
Let's
pretty,
have a look. Red phone box.
Oh my god.
I'm not fucking with you. It's on my bus route. There's phone box of fucking with books in outside the special needs place.
Every time he goes to look something up, now he's gonna look. Now he's gonna look every fact up. We've lost him for the next ten minutes.
Red phone box book exchange.
If you guys go back, if you guys go back and listen to Wayne's facts, whenever he looks up one fact, he looks up every fact that Ant gives him for the rest of the show.
No, that's near Gillingham.
Well, there you go. What do you think about it being a library?
We've got one on my bus route.
But what do you... Oh, fuck, I'm moving.
All right, it's fine. You got one on your bus route. What do you think about it?
Wayne!
What? Sorry.
China has banned time travel on TV, saying that it disrespects history.
What?!
They're not going to sell. They don't like Back to the Future.
There's no Doctor Who.
No Doctor Who.
No Back to the Future.
No Back to the Future.
Ah, that's no wrong. Back to the Future.
No. No Bill and Ted.
No Doctor Who.
No Bill Ted.
No Bill and Ted. No Bill and Ted.
No Bill and Ted.
Apparently.
Oh, apparently.
We know.
Apparently, no like Cyberman.
Cyberman.
We know like Weeping Angels.
Oh, what is that?
Ah, fuck, we played you. My...
I don't know what.
Well, that segment wasn't racist at all.
Right, here's another Chinese one. Wayne.
What is your obsession with the Asians?
Wayne,
what?
Please stop looking.
He's married to one.
I know what you're doing. You're
what?
Still
stop looking him up.
Phone box.
Yes.
Just get away from your computer a minute. Just let's get through this fucking segment.
We all know they're bigger on the inside. It's fine.
Wayne.
That's a police box.
Wayne.
What?
The Chinese Segway ripoff, which was called the Ninebot, used the money it got from selling the ripoff to buy the original Segway company.
Ain't they got a massive counterfeit culture in Asia?
They do have a huge counterfeit.
Ridiculous.
Well, it's not really.
And some of their counterfeit stuff actually got quite a bit of street.
It's not really counterfeit as such, is it?
It's not Asia, it's China. Specifically,
it is just China.
Yeah,
yeah, because they don't want to buy into
correct
sort of. They don't want to import.
Yeah,
correct.
They actually has got their own following. Like they actually will make like a version of like the iPhone.
Yeah. Yes,
yeah,
iPhone.
The
sell Prada cars, lots of cars,
and people actually are quite happy just to get them.
Yeah. Fake watches.
That's all they know. That's all they have.
Yeah, they don't
they
import
don't
anything. Yeah, they don't import anything. So they don't. They make it all and they export it, but they don't import anything specifically.
They just make their own knock-up version of it, which are pretty much exactly the same. So the Segway company made their own Segway, and because it's in China, it's going to fucking sell well. It sold so well that they were able to actually buy Segway out.
Have you guys seen the new Segways that are just the feet?
Yeah, they look fucked up.
Dude, I saw at the airport, I saw like four people on them.
Really?
I did.
Did they have to take their shoes off?
No.
Wayne?
I walked right into that one.
Wayne?
Yeah?
Crows are smart as great apes, apparently, and are able to show imagination, the anticipation of possible future events, to solve problems which require abstract reasoning. It's easy for me to say.
I've been drinking.
Problems which were once only thought possible by humans and the great apes. Okay. Wayne?
Yeah? That was me doing a crow noise, by the way.
Yeah, no,
I like crows. I always like crows.
Because they've got like black heart like yours.
Oh, really? Really, mister, I put plastic down before my wife gets in the car. Really?
If you shat in your pants, I'd make plastic go down before you sat in my car.
I'd say a crow's more.
It's not just aimed at my wife. It's aimed at anyone with a shitty heart.
Oh, specifically, it was aimed at your wife. You fucking heartless motherfucker.
If anyone shit their pants, they'd have plastic put down.
This is the worst Wayne's Facts I've ever done.
I don't know, I'm quite enjoying it.
Yeah, I know you are. I know you are. Wayne.
You sound like you're really stressed. You need a massage. Is. Should we get your woman back?
Wayne.
I take the silence as a yes.
Wayne.
Yes.
At least he answered me nicely. The distance between the United States and Russia is only 2.4 miles.
What was that? What was that?
Tell him again.
I said.
Tell him again.
The distance between the United States and Russia is only 2.4 miles.
Is that real?
Yeah, that's real.
Because I always thought about the map. The map, when it, like that side has got to touch that side, so then they're close.
Yeah.
They are close.
They're close. We're well, part of us is
so why don't you miles? Nick the oil? Oh. Why don't you nick the oil then?
I don't work for
America. Not you, the American.
Oh yeah, let me break down the working relationship between Russia and the United States.
You could
let
set,
me do that
you could
right
like
now.
Stick like a tunnel across like the 2 miles under the water and like drink the oil and then bring it back.
Well, I'm intrigued to know how many miles it is between England and France, because we built a tunnel.
That's a good point.
I
bet
Wayne,
I bet it's more than I bet it's more than
oh,
2.5
I'm back
miles.
Near it now, am I?
You're allowed back near your computer now.
I bet it's
that up. How long is the channel how long is then. Channel tunnel? All
right, let me guess. You want to guess, Ant? Go ahead, go on to guess before he tells us.
It's not that far.
I'm guessing five.
I'm gonna say it's about 6 miles.
So, I'm guessing five.
You're guessing five. Isn't five. It? Wayne, what are you guessing?
31.4 miles.
What?
What?
That's what I'm guessing.
Yeah, you're
because you looked it up.
Yeah,
no,
I
he's
know.
Fucking.
It's 31 miles?
No, that's from. No, I want to know the distance of the water as opposed to.
That's not what
to,
you said. I asked the tunnel and you went,
no,
yes.
No, yeah, because the tunnel's obviously on land as well.
Right.
How far on land is it?
It goes quite a way on each side of the
distance.
Land. I want to know how long the distance
under
between
the
France and England is.
How long
much.
Is the tunnel under the water?
Yeah. Right. What's the distance between England and France?
You know, they tried to build a. They tried to build
all
a tram.
Right. Come on, play the game. Stop waffling. I'm excited. I'm excited by the prospect.
They tried to build a tram, an underwater tram between us and you. You know that, right?
What?
Yeah, they were thinking about building an underwater tram, like a car, like an underwater car that would follow like a metal
submarine.
Yeah, like a sort of like a submarine on a rail. Between
okay, so, all right, I've got an answer for us.
All right, what we got?
It's Wayne shit.
20.6.
It's 20.6.
That's still a long ways.
So if you think that Russia and America is only 2.4, and you look on a map and look at England and France, Jesus Christ,
that's crazy.
That's nothing.
Nothing at all, man.
I like
that's
that.
Literally,
fact. That
is almost
fact.
Literally a tenth of the distance.
Yeah, we have bridges that are longer than 2 miles.
Fuck it, man.
That's crazy.
So you like that fact, Wayne, do you?
I do. That was actually a really good one.
Thank you, mate. Oh, I'm so happy.
Look
now.
At you. You're smiling so much right now.
Right, I've got three more.
Oh,
Wayne.
He's still smiling.
Why does it say on Google 5,518 miles?
Because you've gone from England to America, I'd imagine.
No, I've done distance between US and Russia.
Yeah, that's probably
yeah, that's
from Moscow
probably
to
from Moscow
Washington.
To like Washington D.C.
I'd say.
Yeah.
Oh, but you look at that map; they are really close.
They are,
of course, Alaska to the Siberian.
So fucking David Walliams, Wayne, that'd be a piece of piss to him because he swam that. He swam Dover.
The only problem is,
oh my god, they've got a whales in fucking America?
Of course we do.
Of course they have. They copied all their names. That's where they're from.
That's Wales. Wales is the closest to...
We're from you.
I can't pronounce that. The Yuren Yanu.
We're from you. Why will we not copy you? It's like your kids. It's like sending your kids off to be adults, and all of a sudden, no, I want to name my kid.
Why do you think they've got a place called New York?
Exactly.
Have they got a place called Mount Mowbray?
Probably. It's a big country.
Can I please? Can I please?
Yes,
finish
please.
These facts.
You only get two, right?
No, I've got fucking three. Unfortunately,
all right, let's go.
Wayne.
Yeah.
Breakups are more painful for men. In a study of around 5,705, see, it says in a study of around 5,705, that's a really particular number, but anyway, participants from 96 countries, it was found that whilst women experience intense pain immediately after a breakup, they get over it pretty quickly. Whereas in men, on the other hand, they move on quickly, but remain damaged for longer.
I agree with that.
I completely concur with that as well.
Me too.
Is that 'cause their periods?
What? Amy, please, next time you see him, slap him in the face.
Well, no, it's like, you know, they like release stuff.
It's all like
torture, and then it's like out of the system, literally, and done.
I'm very much, if someone splits up with me, I'm going, yeah, all right, whatever. See you later.
Then he goes into a darkened room and rocks.
And then I'm sitting on a rock, wanking and crying. But there you go.
I think that's because they release stuff.
It's not.
Blood.
Yeah, I cut myself. it's different for everybody, right? I mean, for every relationship, right? It's different for every relationship.
I always said if me and Amy go south, that'll be it.
Mm-hmm.
I want to be an island again.
That's not gonna happen.
What do you mean?
Like my buddy says the same thing, right? If his marriage goes bad, he won't.
No,
ever
I
want to
be an island
again.
I want to be an island.
You're not. And
I'll go traveling again, mate. I'll go traveling
but
again.
But you're gonna find somebody on your travels.
No, I won't.
Yes, you will.
You'll find a rebound.
You'll find rebound. Rebound. Why does he always repeat things? We always find somebody.
You don't listen the fucking first time.
Yes, I do. We do. We just ignore you.
You never bloody acknowledge it.
We just ignore you. It's I agree that women do take it harder, but it does take longer. But it does take longer for men to get it over.
What's that Beavis and Butthead over? He's fucking Beavis and Butthead, isn't he?
He's totally Butthead. Totally. All right. Sorry. Yeah, I agree. I 100% agree.
I'm smashing these two out because I can't even be fucking bothered anymore.
Go for it. Let's go.
Wayne.
Yeah.
The Brave Man's Bridge in Henan, China. Another fucking China one. Boom. Is nearly 980 feet long, hangs 591 feet above the ground, and is made of glass.
Ugh.
Yeah, I saw that.
Glass bridge.
Yeah.
They have like these funny little shoes.
Yeah, people were, they have to wear...
Oh, shit. Oh, no.
What?
You have to take your shoes off to go on it.
Yeah, you have to take your shoes off. But...
Vamp's fucked.
Oh, my God.
Oh, I don't care what this episode's called. It's gotta be...
Please take your shoes off.
It is called Anniversary Episode. Go fuck yourself.
No,
I named the episode.
It's
called Episode 50. Please take your shoes off before listening.
Shoo me the way to go home.
Fine, whatever. Anyway, I did see the stuff. Some people are closing their eyes walking across it.
Yeah, it looks pretty.
See the object, really.
I would love to do that.
Oh, yeah, I'd love that shit.
Me too.
Well, the Brighton Tower, Blackpool Tower, sorry. Blackpool Tower has a glass bit and you can stand on it.
Why are you laughing?
Why would anyone want to see through that shithole? That's more of a shithole than Southend.
There's people 2 o'clock in the afternoon on a hen do when I was there, and they were throwing up on the pavement.
Of course they were, because it's fucking Blackpool, the Las Vegas of England. And that's saying something.
Las Vegas is mostly clean.
Yeah, but what's the shit Las Vegas in your country?
Detroit.
Okay, well,
Detroit is a fucking abortion.
But
times Detroit by two, and that's Blackpool.
Bullshit.
I don't like Blackpool.
Are you serious?
Blackpool is a shit.
It's that bad?
Even by my seaside standards, Blackpool is...
Detroit is literally almost abandoned, like the entire city.
I know, I've seen RoboCop. I know what Detroit's like.
Right? That's funny.
Yes, it was, because RoboCop is almost exactly right. I never realized that until now. RoboCop is almost exactly right.
Is Philadelphia like Rocky?
No, no. Philadelphia is full of fucking cunts.
Yeah, it is full of idiots. But okay, right, Wayne, this is the last one, Funk Funk. And this one's actually a good one. I'm happy with this one, which means you're going to hate it. Mm-hmm. Wayne?
Go on, then.
The Island of Discussion in Scotland is where historically those with arguments were put on with cheese and whiskey to sort out their problems and could not leave until they came to a mutual agreement. I've got a picture of it, and it is like a little Scottish lock. So imagine a little Scottish lock, and there's a little island on the middle of the lock. So they used to row them out there, drop them off. Here's some fucking cheese. Here's some whiskey. Settle your differences. Don't come back until you have.
Is that like the, was it called the Island of Discussion, or was
the
it called
Island Discussion? Of Discussion in Scotland?
I'd like it if
still
that was
there.
Just called Discussion, just Discussion.
It's still there, the Island of Discussion is still
what
there.
Would you have on your Island of Discussion? Would it be whiskey and cheese?
Wine and cheese would be good, but I'm very partial to a whiskey. I would not quarrel with a whiskey.
Bread?
It's got the Irish
no,
whiskey.
No, I want bread.
What, in Scotland?
Yeah, but that's dickhead. What I'm saying. I don't like Scotch.
You don't like Scotch.
No,
bread? Bread?
You just
cheese.
Want bread. You ought to sit why, and gnaw on the
bread 800
can I
times.
Because every time I talk, he interrupts me.
Bread. What's the matter with bread?
Cheese? Bread? Cheese? Bread, cheese. Meat? Yeah. Whiskey? Or wine? Whichever one you prefer. Absolutely. I agree. I agree with this. We should do this
I
now.
I think it's great.
We should do this now. Just put leaders that don't agree with each other on an island and let them right. bicker it out.
White bread.
Cheese board and wine.
So you can make a sandwich instead of.
Why do you lot always have to put stuff in a fucking sandwich?
Because it's good.
They like
it's not
bread,
good unless
they?
It's like even they don't have a roast, do they? They don't have like nice roast chicken or not. They get bread and they fucking dip that in gravy.
We have
everything's
roasts?
Fucking bread.
Do we have roast every fucking November? We have roasts.
Fucking dip bread in
idiot.
Bread.
We have roast every fucking November. It's called Thanksgiving.
We have every
fucking
retard. Sunday, so fuck you.
You are such a fucking retard. Every November we have fucking roast. It's called Thanksgiving.
We have every Sunday and it's called eating.
And that was Wayne's fact.
There you go.
But can I just say one fact?
Oh God. Yes.
This is actually a really good one.
Okay. Oh, all right.
Please.
It would take 1,200,000 mosquitoes each sucking once to completely drain the average human of blood.
That's pretty cool.
Love and marriage, love and marriage. Like a horse and carriage, this I tell you, brother, you can't have one without the other. Love and marriage, love and marriage, it's an institute you can't disparage. Ask the local gentry.
Great, great, great show. All right, guys, so we have six things men complain about in marriage counseling.
I could name 616.
This is from HuffingtonPost.com, which is a website I find very annoying sometimes. But anyway, so you guys, I want to go through this.
Don't Huffington.
I fucking can't stand Huffington Post sometimes. They're just too fucking liberal.
Whoa. Whoa.
See, that's another soundbite. That's another soundbite I want.
Why not? Rewind that. The most liberal American I've ever known and loved is saying he hates the Huffington Post because they're too liberal.
I don't hate them. I just find them annoying sometimes because they're too liberal.
Too liberal.
They're just too liberal.
The guy that watches the Young Turk.
Yes, TYT, Young Turks. Awesome.
And they're not liberal enough.
TYT.
Huffington are more liberal?
Huffington Post is way more liberal than TYT.
Wow.
Yeah.
But you realize that you're the most liberal person I've ever met.
Am I really?
American-wise, yes.
Oh, okay. All right. There you
not
go.
British-wise, but American-wise, okay. Yeah.
All right. Well, that probably makes sense. My wife expects me to be a mind reader, Ant and Wayne. Men talk a lot about how unfair it is that they're expected to know exactly what their wives are thinking and feeling at all times, said Marcia Naoma Berger, a psychotherapist and author of Marriage Meetings for Last Love, 30 Minutes to Relationship You've Always Wanted.
She's the author of Marriage Meetings for Last in Love, but I bet she's never been married.
Might be a possibility. When the husbands misread the situation, they feel like they're somehow the bad guy. Ooh, I'm the bad guy. It's, quote, it's so wrong for women to assume my partner should know how I feel and what I want. I shouldn't have to tell him, said Berger.
I hate that fucking California woman voice that you do.
Wives should be directed, but husbands should can also help by encouraging their spouses to say specifically what they
right,
want.
Do you want me to call an ambulance?
Then suddenly they should either be accommodated or negative, so both of their needs are met. Do you guys think you know what your wives want at all times? Are you guys a mind reader?
Claire's pretty simple.
Speak up, Wayne. We can't hear you.
I said Claire's pretty simple.
Claire's pretty simple in what way?
Fucking hell, coming from him, man. This as well.
I know, right?
She just does her own thing as long as fucking Neighbours is on and she's happy.
Get close to the microphone. I can't fucking hear you.
I know, no. I do this all the time too, because when I'm in the car, I listen and I'm like, what is Wayne saying? I can't hear him. Wayne, speak up. Get closer to the mic.
Okay.
4 for 4.
What? Never heard of it. Anyway,
Mind reader?
I thought I construed this differently. I read this differently.
Okay.
This first one.
All right.
I thought it was me being a mind reader. Maybe I'm.
I
think I've just answered my own question.
It's Amy expecting demeanor, Ryan.
Right. Here's a classic example. I'm in the fucking living room and I'm like, where's the scissors? And she's like, in the cupboard. In the kitchen. I'm like, fair enough, but I'm counting now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I've got 14 cupboards in my fucking kitchen. 14. Which fucking cupboard? The cupboard, she says. The cupboard.
The cupboard.
The cupboard.
Look,
the top drawer. The top drawer.
It's the cupboard.
I've got 1, 2, 3, 4.
Yeah, but don't
five top drawers.
But don't you have certain drawers for certain things? You go to what the most relevant drawer would be.
But you can't say it's in the cupboard. Say it's in the top drawer by the fridge. That's what a man would say. Top drawer by the fridge. Boom. I'm there.
Yeah, but we've got certain drawers for certain things. You'd go to the most relevant one.
Yeah, but Wayne...
Like, you'd have a medical drawer, so you'd just say drawer in the kitchen if you want plasters.
Kitchen.
Common sense.
But how many drawers you got in your kitchen?
4. But you go to the medical one because you want plasters.
A medical drawer in your
kitchen. Yeah, Claire's fucking so ill all the time.
I'm not going to say. It does kind of make sense. You do have a junk drawer. You have a knife
drawer. Yes, I have a junk
drawer. I've got a drawer in the living room, which, like, all my electrical cables going, like, chargers and, like, electrical bits. So if Claire goes, I put it back in the drawer, then I'd go to, like, where the remote's older.
All right.
Okay,
I'm speaking about, like, a random item
that
doesn't belong to a drawer. Fucking hell, you're defending the women here.
Wouldn't the scissors go in the junk drawer?
No, I'd say
I was using the scissors.
My scissors always go in the knife drawer.
An inanimate object that I picked out of my head.
Okay, I got you.
Another item then.
So she expects you to know where and what she's talking about at every minute of the day.
And women do tend to do that.
I got you.
Like, where's me trousers? They're upstairs. Where fucking upstairs? Like, where are they upstairs? Oh, that cat is doing my head in. I've got to kick him out in a minute. He's fucking going to punch him in the face.
No. I agree. I don't have these issues, although I don't have the same issues, like where things are or what things are, but I have had the same issues that they're talking about as far as feelings and knowing what they feel. I can't jump into your head, man. I don't get that. I never understood that. It's just too complicated. I don't... Women, help us out. Tweet us, @CerebralSatire. Let us know why we should understand you. All right, here's the second one. Late night arguments are getting out of hand, son. He's just about to drift off to sleep, And then his wife rolls over and brings up some major household or relationship issue that needs addressing right away. Sleep be damned. It may sound like a relative minor problem, but it's an almost universal complaint among married men, said Elizabeth J. Lamont, a couples psychotherapist and founder of DC Counseling of Psychocentry. By the way, this is from, oh yeah, I already said that. Often, from the woman's perspective, the topic feels so important that she can't possibly sleep until...
I think she speaks like this.
Oh.
I know. I think she's a bit more geeky.
Often, from Jewish, the woman's...
Do Jewish woman. Old, 45-year-old, oh, old Jewish woman, please.
God damn it.
I often... From the woman's perspective...
Often, from the woman's perspective...
Too old. He's gone.
God damn it. Stop.
Too old.
Okay. We get a lot of these to go through. I'm just going to go through. Often from the woman's perspective, the topic of so important that she can't possibly sleep until things have been adequately discussed, Lamont explained. But for many men, this is a least appealing time to talk. They feel like they're exhausted and need to sleep is being dismissed by their wives. To curb unexpected late-night convos, Lamont suggests carving out some time. Maybe it's 10 minutes after work or right after... No, don't what hit me up.
Like it's room... Like, it's not a dot-to-dot. We're not playing fucking dot-to-dot relationships here. Like, these people fucking drive me mental. She's probably on about 100 grand a year for fucking speaking shit.
Look,
she's
I'm
up
just
there
saying,
with the fucking vagina artist to me.
I'm just saying, don't talk to me 10 minutes after work. That's not going to go well. Now,
don't talk to me when I wake up.
No,
just
no, no,
fucking
that
don't.
Too, that too. But right after dinner is a good time to talk. I like that. After dinner,
like,
get a wine.
Me and Amy don't argue, so what the fuck?
Well, I know you guys don't argue, but I'm just saying, when spouses can give their full attention and mental energy to the issues of matter. So she just hits you like after lunch, after dinner, when you get home. I mean, if you're fine when you... I am exhausted when I get home. I just want to go take a shower and get a beer in my hand. After I'm done
I'll
with that,
what,
I'm fine.
If you're,
but
if
don't,
you're finding that you're having... late night arguments this is the quote, late night arguments are getting out of hand, right? If you're finding you're having more than three of those a month, get out of a relationship. Because me and my partner have been in a relationship for over 6 years and we've had three or four maybe. Like, we bicker, of course we do, but argument is bigger than a bicker, isn't it? I mean, that's crazy. If you feel the necessity to have like those late night arguments, like, and there's still something on your mind, like still something stewing on your mind that you have to get it out, then come on, just get the fucker out.
I'm trying to go back to
me and Amy are that honest with each other that we just fucking say what you want to fucking say.
That's good.
Jesus Christ.
That's good. That's good.
Don't fucking boil it up until you're about to fucking roll over when I'm asleep.
Yeah, I'm trying
to be a bitch.
I'm trying to think back when I was living with my ex. We did talk about things in the bed, but it wasn't like, as far as I know, the agreement was always, we can never go to sleep angry. Like, we did it once, and then that was it. Like, we couldn't do that again.
Got to sort shit out.
Yeah, you have to sort shit out. So, we did have chats in the bed, but it wasn't like late night chats. It was like chats. But, I mean, we would normally discuss stuff, like I said, after dinner, when both of us are full, we got some type of drink in our hand, we're discussing things. So we're having enjoying topics. So we're actually trying to suss things out rather than arguing. We're just discussing, which I think
what
is better than
is,
arguing. Yeah.
If you don't do that, you'll end up having 3 days where you just don't talk.
Yeah. That's
and
it.
Then
that's the worst.
On
that's
the
it.
Fourth day,
that's
you'll
it.
Talk and you're like, well, what was the last 3 days about?
Mm-hmm. Why didn't why didn't we have sex the last 3 days?
Exactly. Yeah. Why didn't we just fucking talk about what we're talking about right now?
Three days ago.
We could have
just
banged it out and done. Yeah. You know, like it's humans being humans, I suppose.
Yeah. Wayne, what do you say? Late night arguments?
Look, I tried saying that I never go to bed angry. I just get it done there and then.
You do?
Yeah, I say what I think as I go along. Claire hoards a little bit and then that'll come out in a melee of everything. But that's just her
really?
Personality.
Does she really hold stuff?
yeah, like she'll take everything, then that's fine, and it's fine, and then suddenly it's just like one little thing, she'll get angry, and you're like, don't think it's about that, and then everything flies out.
Oh, it's not. Do you know good, what that man. Is, Wayne? It's because her original argument ain't good enough.
Yeah, it's
she has to
stack
stuff. It's the whole thing, right? She stacks, she stacks the argument, so it
then piles you can't
up.
Win the argument. So exactly, that's why Dave can level with her. I just tell her, overloaded. Why don't you say stuff pissing you off as you go along?
And I'm sorry, women, because we do have women listeners. That's a typical woman. Thing to do.
It is a very
they think they're being nice. They think they're being nice by keeping it to themselves, but at the end of the day, that only causes long term.
And it's a trick. It's a trick too. So like when you're arguing or when you it's not even have to be arguing. When you're discussing stuff, and all of a sudden they bring up three other things, you're like, wait a minute.
But yeah, but like you kissed you that girl like 12 years ago. Like, can remember that? Remember when you kissed that girl like 12 years ago?
What are you talking
in that
about?
Nightclub?
We were discussing why I play Xbox so much, not the fact that I kissed a girl 12 years ago.
Can you remember though when you kissed that girl like 12 years ago?
Yeah, I do remember that. But why are we talking about that right now?
And what about that time that you bummed that blow?
What? Look, I had one night.
Wet patch on your sofa. Look, I know you're cheating with it.
I had one night with the bloke and one night with the sofa. But that was it was way before you were in the picture. Why are we talking about that now?
Fuck your Xbox. You play the Xbox too much and you bum that bloke.
That has nothing to do with the fact that I bummed the bloke.
You're playing with him.
She doesn't appreciate me when speaking with husbands who've cheated. Psychotherapist and Newman Method, co-creator M. Greg
Method. Wow,
that's what it says. Newman Method, co-creator M. Gary Newman said the.
Stop the fucking punk.
He created his own method.
Hang on. So he created the Newman Method.
Yes.
And
his name is...
American listeners probably won't get this, but anyone European will get this. The creator, his name is Gary Newman.
It is Gary Newman.
In cars.
And if you're American, just look up Gary Newman.
It's the lead singer of Cars?
No, he's done a record called Cars.
Oh, all right.
80s pop star, man. Come on.
So the biggest complaint usually isn't a lackluster sex life, but the rather feeling underappreciated by their wives. The problem is too many women think that they've overly appreciated their husbands.
Cars.
They'll reduce their husband's desire to please her.
Cars.
It's quite the opposite.
Cars.
Actually.
Ours.
Men are energized when they feel their wives are appreciating them. He says. So I agree with this. This is what caused me to text another person while I was dating someone.
You didn't appreciate her.
No, she didn't appreciate me. I felt like she did not appreciate me. She was concentrating too much on her job and she wasn't appreciating me enough. That's what I felt like. Yeah, I get it. I get it, Wayne. Thank you. You can turn it off now. I get it. I'm going to hang up on you in a minute if you don't turn that off, please. Thank you.
We don't threaten people with cutting off on this show. Thank you very much.
I'm trying to get through these six things.
So you play racist Asian music in the background. That stays on. I fucking play Gary Newman, which is a Gary good Newman. Song. And you
classic.
Fucking...
Gotta pay off the cool.
Do you know he's a pioneer of electronic music? But getting back to your point anyway.
Thank you.
Appreciation's a different thing. Like, I don't know. I don't know. I don't know how to answer that one because I appreciate Amy. She appreciates me. I wouldn't know how to not appreciate her. You know, she's there. I've got to appreciate her. You know what I mean? I don't know how to answer that one as such.
No, but you don't think she'd appreciate you?
Of course she does. I think she knows I'm here. She knows I'm looking after children. I'm out working. Surely there's some sort of appreciation there for that.
Wayne, what about you?
I just don't want to get kicked off a call.
Nice. He's kicking us off.
I don't dare speak now.
Wayne, what about you?
I feel like I had my bollocks ripped off. Do you feel like I'm in a marriage?
Do you feel? is that what your marriage is like?
No, it's like they married Claire is easier.
You think so?
Christ, no wonder.
Oh, God.
She don't kick you out of the house
I'm never going to live this down.
If I put something on as a joke lightly in the background, she don't go, get out of my house.
I'm never going to live
that. She'd wait a few weeks and throw that in with something else.
Never going to live that. But what do you think about feeling underappreciated?
I feel a little bit underappreciated now.
On the call or in life with your wife? No, that rhymes. In life with your wife with a knife.
Your wife is a strife.
Trying to think of other.
Strife. I've just done it, mate. Yeah.
Strife. Mm. Do you really feel unappreciated?
Not by Claire, no.
No, okay. All right. I'll just check in. Just check.
Fucking hell, let's get through these.
Thank you. She doesn't back me up when I discipline the kids.
Now, this one is fair. Obviously, I'm the only one here with kids.
Yep.
So I'm the only
one.
No,
but I can comment because I feel like she doesn't back me up when something happens, just a general incident, and someone says, you should try this or you should do this just on anything in life.
Mm-hmm.
And I say, that's a shit idea. She'll ignore me. She'll do what anyone else says. And then she'll go, oh, I'm sorry, you were right. But she'll never back me up or do what I say. Like, say directions to somewhere. Yeah. I'll say, well, no, that way is the way to go to it. Mm-hmm. She'll follow them and get to the wrong place. And she'll go, oh, I'm sorry. And it happens all the time. She'll never back me up because she don't want to offend anyone else. She's quite happy to say, no, I'm not doing it your way.
I totally agree. You need to support each other and you need to have each other's backs. Now, at the end of the day, you're mates as well as fucking partners.
Mm-hmm.
And that's whole deal. So you've got to have...
It seems like we're, like, sometimes that she thinks that she can say no to me, but no one else. She thinks she can say no because we're so close.
Okay.
And that is really annoying. It's like, you will listen to me one day. And she'll go, well, they were telling me it was that, you know, to do this.
Yeah.
Mate. I do this.
Don't worry about it, Wayne. Yeah. She's a dyke.
I do this too. I don't typically trust. And I think it has something to do with my upbringing, but I don't trust
in the dungeon.
I don't necessarily trust the Great women Pleasure. Companions I've Fritzel. Had over the men companions
I've
had. I
got raped by my uncle. He touched my bum.
He touched my dick.
My balls.
I've got a whole dungeon full of children.
So, Ant, what about the kids, Ant?
He uses things as tools.
See, if that was me, wait.
Was that in the cadence of the fucking Game of Thrones? Was that cadence of Game of Thrones?
No.
I think it was.
I was watching Walking Dead earlier, which we wanted to talk about. We'll talk about it next week on a Halloween special. How about that?
So good. But, oh my god, it was so good.
That's a little segue. But Nick, anyway, on to the disciplined kids. Me and Amy have different ways of doing things. We definitely I think we're on the same page most of the time. I'd say 90% of the time we're on the same page. Sometimes, like, I may be slightly harder than Amy, but you know, I'm dad. You know, I'm supposed to be a bit more strong and
That's a little sexist.
I know. Hang on. Let me finish.
Dads have typically got the reputation for being the pushovers.
Let me finish. But on the flip side of that, I'd say also I am the pushover as well.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm like, when shit goes real down, don't fuck with dad.
Yeah.
Like, don't let your dad see you do this.
Mm-hmm.
But on like a sort of a lower end of the scale, it's just like, yeah, dad let you get away with that. And yeah, I think we've got each other's back. I think we're pretty good. Yeah. Like, for instance, I put Lola May on a naughty step. Amy don't agree with a naughty step. And we had a little discussion. She was like, I was like, why don't you like naughty step? We had a little discussion. Mm-hmm.
Did you put
Amy
on the naughty step?
We come to a medium, all right? I'll take her off the medium step and we'll try something else. It's all about a relationship.
No, I like that. My buddy does the same thing. His oldest niece was almost...
I mean, I ain't Adrian Peterson. I ain't going to fucking knock the shit out of my kid tree, am I?
Exactly. I mean, his oldest daughter was almost perfect throughout her entire twos and threes and fours and fives. And she's a little trouble in school lately, but not that big of a deal. The middle child, holy fuck. I've never had to deal with such a rambunctious, crazy child in my life. And she has been to the naughty step a lot.
See, I like the naughty step because it's something that's harmless.
It's a calm down thing. It's
exactly. It's you take 5 minutes. It's take your breath, relax.
Think about what you're doing.
Just chill out.
Yep.
Yeah, but you know, Amy's not a fan of it, so we'll find a different way. And you know, and that's part about being a relationship. Yeah. It's about compromise. Everything's a compromise.
Yeah.
And I'd say that's probably one of the most important words in a relationship, compromise.
Yeah, Wayne, I understand. I'm usually on the opposite end. I usually don't trust my partners with actual real information. I don't know why I do that. I think it has something to do with my parents' relationship.
Because I raped you.
Because they're what?
Nothing.
But yeah, I agree with you too, Wayne. She's not interested in sex.
It's Ant, by the way, but you call me Wayne all you want. That's fine.
I was talking to Wayne too.
Why was you talking to Wayne?
Because I agreed.
I would like to be part of the show as well.
I agreed with him as far as...
Wayne.
Well, I know. I agreed with him as far as not, like, Claire not trusting. I have the same issue. I don't really... A lot of times
it's not that she don't trust me. It's just that I'm the only person she's comfortable in saying no.
Would you trust Wayne? No.
I wouldn't trust Wayne.
There you go. So.
That was dating
can't
Wayne.
Really blame the girl.
That was dating Wayne. I wouldn't trust Wayne either. She's not interested in sex, guys. Sex may not be as hot and heavy as it used to be, but for most couples, it still needs to be a priority, Newman said. And their
men most complain
about starting to feel more like... Men said they may often complain that they're starting to feel more like roommates than spouses. Their wives just don't seem to be interested in sex anymore.
Don't do any more fucking quotes from this idiot.
What? Why?
Because we can get through them quicker without fucking...
All right. Well, there you go.
I mean, sex is an important part of any relationship. Obviously, Amy's been pregnant for a while. While she's pregnant, my sex drive goes to zero. Honestly, it does. It goes from 100 to zero. But now, like, she's had the baby... Seriously, I'm over the last couple of days.
The blood is flowing back.
It's flowing, and I've gone from naught to like I'm at a good 65 at the minute. Come next week, by the time she listens to this, I'll be at 100. But obviously, women are a bit like after baby, they're a bit like, you know, a bit sore and stuff, yeah, and they don't want to have sex in the first 4 weeks.
They still don't feel like they're sexy.
Jesus. So, Amy, if you're listening to this...
Come on, come blow me.
I'm at 100. You're probably at about 30 now.
Come blow me.
So, if you're at 30, you're taking up the ass. Done.
Wayne, you haven't had sex in a long time, and you're married.
So?
That's what he's talking about. He said these are the most things men complain about in marriage counseling. We've always Anne and I have always said you guys need to go to marriage counseling. So
not that bothered.
That's not good.
Yes, you are.
That is not good.
Why?
If you're not bothered,
you're beating your dick.
I like the fact that you're telling me what I'm looking for in my marriage.
I'm not telling you.
I'm more worried that you're getting fully satisfied by beating your dick,
yes,
than you are to spending, yes, like emotional.
I can't
time
see the issue with that
because it's two becomes one. I need some love like I never needed love before. Wanna make love to you, baby.
How about these relationships then?
Love
that don't work at all because they hate each other, but they just enjoy shagging. Is that a better relationship?
That's not what we're talking about. That's not what we're talking about. We were talking about your relationship, not anybody else's.
Every relationship has to have some sort of certain intimacy, and it does.
We're intimate. I hold her every night when we sit on the sofa. I cuddle her in bed. Why does it have to involve my penis with her?
Because that's called intimacy for a reason.
That's sort of why we're here.
To become one, Wayne. To become one.
That's why we have dicks.
It's
not so you could wank like a monkey.
So all the old people that are giving up doing it because they've got no sex drive.
No.
They've been there.
They've got the fucking t-shirt, mate.
And old people
color arrangements and sizes.
Old
of
people
what they've done already.
Old people statistically have more sex than most 30-year-olds do.
That Keith Richards has more sex in one fucking day than you've had in your life.
Oh, that goes without saying.
And he's 78.
He's a bit of a boy, though.
He is a bit of a boy.
I'm just saying, Wayne, it's not the fact that we're telling you what to do. We're just concerned, buddy. We're just concerned.
Got to be intimate with your
Got
partner.
To, man. It's where you meet. That's your common
your
ground.
Penis in a
that's
pajama.
Where everyone. That's where everyone's equal. It's the common ground. It's where everyone. Where everything's stripped from you, and it's just you and her in the moment
to
of moments.
One. Keep talking. I'll do the
love
thing in the background. You keep telling
him
about that because that was really good. What you were just saying was really good,
wasn't it? I mean, it really is.
You keep saying it, and you keep
that's,
doing the, like, motivational speech.
It's the moment.
So there's you with your logic. I hate to use this because I don't want to be that person, but I'm going to have to because it's going to be the only way you show up.
Go ahead.
But there's you with your idealistic views of marriage and how it should should work. Who's the one that's been married for? Let me work it out.
You want to let me work it out like you have to do multiplication?
What year are we in?
2015, you cunt.
That must be 7 years then.
7 years you've been married.
Yeah.
And you don't,
know how long you've been married.
But you don't have a marriage.
I have to work out, but then again, I don't know how old I am, do I?
How long has it been since you've had sex?
I don't know.
That's not good.
2 years?
No, not that long.
8 years?
I just find it easier. Self-satisfy and then...
That's not good. That's not a marriage, Wayne.
Does it matter?
Yes, that's what we're saying, Wayne.
As long as we're both happy.
No.
Why have we got to have sex to entertain you?
That's weird. Wayne, that's not a marriage. That's a roommate.
Can you imagine watching him fucking knock one out on YouTube? Exactly. Jesus Christ.
You two are the only ones that seem bothered. Honestly, I can't see the problem with her. I'm happy. Why should I change the way I am with Claire to satisfy you two?
It's not to satisfy us. It's to help you.
You're telling me my marriage is wrong. And
we're not saying that. We're saying that it could be better.
No, I'm saying it's part of an avid, normal relationship where you express yourselves in that way and you can be intimate with each other.
Yeah.
But you knocking one out. We express ourselves quite happily in different ways. So what's the issue with that? Why has marriage got to conform to one way? Marriage can be conceived to whoever the person's in the marriage.
We're not saying it's one way. We're not saying that at all.
I'm just saying you knocking one out 12 times a day... spitting on
and if you want to celebrate your marriage with Amy by putting a silly paper hat on and dancing around, then I say go for it. It's to put it to the person who wants to be whatever they want to do.
We don't disagree.
Don't tell someone in their marriage they've got to do that.
We're not telling people to do that. We're just saying...
You said my marriage is broken because we don't have
sex. That's not at all what we did. Go back and listen. That is not what we said.
My marriage could be better.
Yeah, I did say that.
What would add to it?
Sex.
But why? If we're forcing it.
Why can't we just do what we want to do? Because it's an
intimate... If I cook her a nice meal and sit down and do stuff with her that way, why is having sex going to make that
because
better?
Because I see what you're saying, Wayne. Do what suits you.
Don't do what should be popular culture.
Okay, all right. Can we rebut now, please?
Wayne, I say that, when you look at like the stigma of it, what you're doing would be stigmatized in some regard because you're not intimate with your missus. It's almost like your roomies as such, which is fine. But we know that you've got a great relationship with Claire. Like, we know that. Mm-hmm. We're fucking your mates. We know that.
Absolutely.
But sometimes you do need that sort of intimacy. We're just fucking joshing with you. We don't know what goes on behind the scenes, really. We only get what you say.
Exactly.
So we're just taking the piss. But, you know, only you can know that your intimacy levels are as high as they should be.
But, Wayne, you...
Because intimacy is a ridiculously important thing in a relationship. Now, you're saying that you're intimate in other ways, like the cuddling and stuff. We don't know that. Like, we just get the bullshit matiness of, like, taking the piss. Like... But you know how intimate you are with her, and that's all that matters, isn't it?
You have to admit, Wayne, that there's a certain...
I can't see what the issue is. If you're getting what you want from a marriage,
yeah,
and you're happy...
Yeah, why not?
There's couples that have amazing sex, but they fucking hate each other.
Wayne, hang on, Ant. We're your mates,
and we're going to take the piss no matter what.
Hang on, Ant. We're not saying that what you're doing is wrong. That's not what we're saying. We're saying that there is a type of intimacy of the joining of the flesh that you can't really achieve in anything else because we've had that experience. Now, if you think you can achieve it somewhere else, that's great. That's fantastic. But Ann and I don't think that you can do that.
If that's the only thing holding your marriage together, then
I worry. And if that's the one thing that you crave from a marriage and you need to set your objectives differently.
Whoa.
There we go. Done.
Whoa. Big dog on campus all of a sudden. You think you can run everybody else's marriage now?
No.
Yeah,
I'm
you
just
do.
Saying if that's the one issue that you need to go to psychiatrist or whatever and moan
about. No. There's six we've already read. We've already read the six and only one of them consists of sex. So you can't say that that's the only one.
I'm just saying, if that is the one thing you're going moaning about, then you need to set your objectives differently.
What? I disagree. I disagree, Wayne, because what you've just said is your intimacy levels and your prerogatives in your relationship are different to other people's. So why is it can't switch that and other people's relationships are like that?
Yeah.
Surely
then
that's
they're obviously
just,
having issues because they're going to have these meetings.
Yeah, but... But you see, then that's a massive contradiction.
He's
in
not
terms.
Gonna have. Yeah, he's not gonna. He doesn't understand.
That's a contradiction in terms of what you've just stated.
Yeah.
What I'm saying, if you're going moaning about that, then you need to set different objectives. Well,
so all of a sudden,
Wayne, that's a really important part of their relationship.
Yeah. All of a sudden, the judgee becomes the judger, Wayne. All of a sudden, you're the one judging because you think they base their relationship on sex, and then you think because. They do that, you think they're less of a relationship because you don't do that.
No, I'm just stuff.
That's what you said. That's exactly what you just said. I know. When we're not judging your relationship. We're just saying that we, as Aunt and I, think that sex is an important part of our relationship because it brings
to me,
intimacy.
To me, it is. To me, it's not up there. I'm not like fucking saying, oh, like,
if we don't have
not
blah,
it
blah,
on
blah.
A pedestal.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm just saying, as a normal relationship, it I've helps. Got to be intimate with someone to share that intimacy
I agree.
With someone. So to me,
there's
important.
A line.
Wayne, it's not as important, but me and Wayne are different. And that's what makes life brilliant. That's what makes humans brilliant. That we're all different. We all love different things, you know, and each relationship is different. But we're talking about the stigma of the norm as such, inverted commas. Mm-hmm. And to a lot of couples, a lack of intimacy is a big deal.
I agree.
And that can be an issue in a relationship. I mean, during Amy's pregnancy, it's not been a big deal for me. I'll tell you what, give it fucking 6 more weeks and it will be an issue. Definitely. Me knocking one out in a shower is not sufficient intimacy with my partner. Mm-mm. You know, but that's as a parent because we don't get to spend as much time together. You know, Wayne's like saying, oh, he can have opportunities where he can cuddle his missus on the sofa and stuff like that. We don't get that. We've got fucking kids running around half the day. You know, we put the babies to bed. We're fucking knackered. We go to bed anyway. So it's a different sort of relationship. It's a different vibe. It's horses for courses. And that's the way it is. And I can certainly see why people go to marriage counselling because they're not getting enough sex. Get fucking laid.
Are you going to do a wait for a start to fall? Tom Selleck. All that. Steve that Gutenberg. Works.
Ted Danson. Huh? Jack. Whew. Angela. Whew. Oh, you look different. What happened?
Dude likes men.
Three incredibly eligible men hoping to meet some incredibly perfect women.
So many women in so little time.
Now, at last, they're about to find that one girl who will sweep them off their feet.
That's a baby.
It's a baby.
Of course it's a baby.
It's your baby.
No, it's not my baby. It's Jack's baby.
The child doesn't look anything like me. I have more hair.
Well, I want to see the way you three big guys handle this one.
So while I was interrupted, that was the trailer for 3 Men and a Baby.
That film is fucked up. What a slut. Like, if you look back at that movie, you think, so she fucked 3 blokes and she don't know which... who were, like,
no,
best mates?
No, that's not the fucking... No! You've never seen the fucking film then, have you?
Obviously not.
She What's had Ted Danson's baby. They're 3 bachelors living in a fancy, swanky apartment together and she dumps the baby back to Ted Danson. Then
Wait,
they look
what?
After the baby.
What? Who's the dad? Who's the dad?
Ted Danson.
So Ted Danson's the dad.
She dumps
the
baby back in there.
Why does she dump the baby?
Because she has fucking like postnatal or whatever.
All right, so she's gone.
And then
what happens?
She has postpartum.
Right, yeah, that makes no sense to me at all.
So they're living like in this fucking swanky thing, bachelors together. They're having
the three of them having parties,
fucking shagging women.
Yeah, they're roommates.
Then suddenly they find this baby on the doorstep, and it turns out it's Ted Danson.
On the doorstep.
With a note.
So she is a cunt.
Yeah.
Oh, she left the note. Good on her.
You're a horrible mother.
This baby. Then she realised she wants the
baby.
Was
it in winter in New
York
by any chance?
So she takes the baby back. And then they miss the baby, so they run after her. And it turns out that she actually quite liked Tom Selleck, so they end up a couple, and that's the end of the film. They will end up as a happy family.
So
she moves in
with...
Who's
the third one?
Oh,
the
he's just from Police Academy. He's just
the
there.
The guy from Police Academy.
Yeah, he's just there.
He's just there. He's
he
the
does some
one.
Cheetos adverts and stuff. He does voiceovers, and that's about it.
Okay. All right.
So what
happens on two
Three Men and a Little Lady? The
so
sequel.
Wait a minute.
What happens on that one?
Hang on.
No, I want to know. I'm really intrigued.
Why are we?
I love these films. They're actually going to do.
Wayne's giving us
Three Men
movie
and a Bride
review.
Soon.
I'm going to get a beer.
I can't wait. I'm a mark.
He's gone, mate. Go on. Tell me. This is like Ant's movie reviews back. Go on. Good movie, is it? So, or
I love it. Three Men
on,
and a Little.
Tell me about it.
Which one do you want? Three Men and a Baby or Three Men and a Little Lady?
Well, you just give me Three Men and a Baby, so...
Want the same again for... So basically... I don't think they stay together. And she
Aaron
moves
Tom
back... No, and she's English, so she moves back to England with the kid, who's like a bit older now.
Oh, she's older now.
And she's going to now get married to this English bloke who's evil because he's English.
Let me tell you, is he an upper-nose cunt?
Yes, he looks like Bill Nye.
Shock. Yeah, go on.
So they get
planned. Does a marriage get halted in any way?
Yes.
Yes. Yes. I've honestly never seen it.
So basically, Tom Selleck and that go over to England for her wedding because, like, good people. And then he realises he's still got feelings for her.
Oh,
so
no.
Does he
marry her at the same church?
Yes.
Oh, fantastic. I've got to see it now because I've just
Can we talk about the article now?
Let's talk about the article. Everyone go see Three Men. What would you give that out of 5, Wayne?
Probably get it on Netflix.
I'd give it fucking 500. I love it.
500 out of 5. There you go.
I do. I love fucking those two films.
Why?
500 out of 5, guys. So go see Three Men and a Little Baby and Three Men and a Little Lady. I'm looking for Three Men and a Little Vagina. So.
Yeah, there we go.
I love Ted Danson.
Ted Danson's awesome. So anyway, this whole fucking start of this story, which has taken 25 minutes.
Thank you.
This is about an all-male thruple, inverted commas, are planning on starting a family together. So three male nurses are now planning to take their polyamorous relationship to the next level by having children together. I'm not going to say their names because it's irrelevant.
Doesn't matter.
They've been living together as a threesome or a thruple since 2012.
They really call it a thruple?
A thruple.
Oh, yeah. All right.
So Adam and Shane were previously married before meeting a guy called Sebastian. I'm glad I didn't name my fucking son that now.
Me too.
Sebastian in a nightclub, and last year divorced so Sebastian would feel properly involved in the arrangement. Fair enough. So Shane 29 said, "We're the happiest we've ever been. All our dynamics and personalities work so well in our relationship. The three of us bring out the best in each other." Adam added, "We don't want Sebastian to be excluded or feel like the third wheel in our relationship. So Shane and I decided to get a divorce so that we found a new commitment between the three of us. Instead, we want to make sure we are all equally bound and obligated to each other in our relationship." Shane added, "We all sleep in a king-size bed together. It's necessary that when there's three people in a relationship, as well as two dogs..."
Call your boyfriends dogs.
I know, it's a bit of a cunt, isn't it? "...who end up in getting in your bed. The trio are now looking to have children using all of their genetics."
How's that possible?
I don't know. Let's listen to what Shane says. Shane said, "I have two sisters who have both offered to carry our children for us as surrogates, and we are willing to donate their eggs as well. My sisters actually argue over which one of them will carry our baby first. I feel so lucky."
Does that mean he wants to fuck his sister?
I added the laughing. "Meanwhile, Sebastian's sister will probably donate her eggs too so that they can keep it in the family."
Oh, gotcha.
"So we want to mix our genes enough so our kids are genetically close to us as possible. But we are open to adoption too. Children are a huge part of their future plans." I added the laugh.
I know you did. It was hilarious.
But Beginning their relationship, the men were nervous that this was the first polyamorous, situation any of them had ever experienced. Shane said something else. I can't bother to do the gay voice. The threesome insists that their first relationship is... I just said gay voice. That's bad.
It's not good.
I'm doing a gay voice now, so it doesn't matter. The threesome insists their relationship is like any normal couple's, having dinner with another, looking at the two dogs, Tito and Tux, and sharing a bed together as the three. However, Adam, Shane, and Sebastian don't think they will add a fourth partner to their thruple. Well, what would be a fourth partner to a thruple be? A thupple?
A gangbang?
Or a fumble?
A fumble?
Quarterbang?
A fumble. A
quarterbang? I like that. Quarterbang? Quarterbang?
Quarterbang. But yeah, so what do we think about these guys? Three guys. Three fairly decent guys. All in good jobs. All nurses. All around their late 20s. And they're in a polyamorous relationship, which means they all just fuck each other and live together as a couple, but there's three of them and they want to adopt a baby. What do you think about this? Because obviously it brings up things about parenting and stuff like that, and I'm sure the Jesus lovers are gonna have a fucking field day on this one.
But
what do you personally think about it as a non-religious guy? I mean, what putting religion completely out the context on this, what do you feel about this as a human being?
Wayne, what about you?
As long as they're not harming anyone, I'm really happy for them. If they can actually provide a stable home for the kid, go for it.
I'm all for it. You know what? I'm fucking all for it. I really am. I don't think doing...
probably more stable home than what other fucking normal conventional, air quotations.
Let's put it this way. We're in a dire straits in this country, in our country in particular. I know these guys are from America and that's fine, but we're in dire straits in this country getting adopted children and children that could be like foster parents over here. And we're really struggling for foster parents over here. If these guys want to adopt a foster child, I am all fucking for that. Surrogate, I might be less, a little bit less. I must say that, honestly.
Why?
On an ethical level.
Why?
Because who's the dad?
Who cares?
Kid might.
Yeah, they're all dads.
I get that, but at least on a foster level, the kid knows.
Kids don't.
Your dad. Kids, you know, all three of them are your dad.
Being with in a gay relationship, kids don't care. They don't care who their dad, as long as they have people that love them.
The gays argument would be they shouldn't be in a gay relationship because you're teaching a kid bad ethics with regards to that.
They just don't. The family is going to change in the next 50 years so much.
Oh, fuck yeah. It's fucking changing.
What the fuck
is a polyamorous relationship?
Anything, three or
10
more.
10 years ago, have you ever heard that word in your life? 10 years
no,
ago.
Not 10.
To be honest,
not
Dan, 10. You hadn't heard about 10 minutes ago.
No. 10 minutes ago, I'd never heard of that word.
Not 10 years ago.
In 20 years ago, it'll be rife.
Five?
Everyone will be fucking that.
Probably 20 years ago, I'd never heard of a gay person. So
probably eight or 7 years ago, probably.
I've been specific.
I've heard. Well, what because the
specific?
First...
He's pinning it down, Wayne. 7 years ago.
I know the...
7 years ago.
I'm going to do my Alan Bennett. Can I do my Alan Bennett impression now? I've always wanted to do
that. I don't know who that is, but go ahead.
No, I won't. You look up Alan Bennett, and then I'll do one day. Everyone look up Alan Bennett. Listen to him, and I'll do an Alan Bennett impression.
I don't know. I know specifically the first time I've ever heard of a polyamorous relationship because I watched it on a sort of a documentary. I guess you can say sort of a documentary. This first time I learned about a polyamorous
relationship. Two girls and one guy and two guys and one girl.
The example that they used was a couple that was married. So let's say Amy and Aunt are married, and then Aunt finds another woman and Amy finds another man, and then they all have a relationship in the same house. And they have children.
Wasn't that just like back in the old days? That's just called swinging, isn't it?
No, because they were together. They were all together. So it's okay. Not swinging is trading partners, a one-time deal. It's not a permanent. This is a permanent relationship that they had.
Okay. All right. So Wayne, what do you think about this whole situation?
Like I said, if they can produce a stable home, What's the issue? I don't care what anyone else perceives. We're going back to this one. Would it be the kids' fault if they get bullied for having three parents? That's more, I think, a damn indictment on the actual kid doing the bullying rather than them.
By the time that kid goes through school, if they're born in the next 2 years, it's not going to be a big deal.
No.
It's not going to be a big deal.
Like I said, that will probably be a happier. They seem like they're really caring about each other's feelings, so they're probably going to be great parents.
This is my
thing.
They
actually generally do look like three people in love, you know? And
This is my issue with it.
Your issue with it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Knowing them, they probably don't have enough sex.
They're not anti-religious.
Well, now. like I'm the only one in this podcast that said that Wayne and Claire doesn't have enough sex. Like, I'm the one.
They don't like Kevin Smith.
Thanks, man.
Wasn't that funny? My issue was
on The Walking Dead this week. So
The Talking Dead.
Talking. That's the one.
Talking Dead. My issue this week was it's going to be a difficult. It's already difficult enough to raise a child with two people. How difficult is it going to be to raise a child with three people? Let alone of the three same set. You really think so? You just said in the previous article that you and Amy sometimes have difficult of the way you guys raise the one child. Imagine having another person's input on
it's
that.
It's easier because you've got the old 2 out of 3 thing.
But that's worse.
You become a dictatorship like China.
That's not good.
I don't know, man. You think that these people are all nurses, so they're all probably going to work different shifts, etc. like that. So
here's the thing, okay? So, like, you said that you and Amy have you agree with the timeout step. She disagrees with the timeout step, okay?
Yeah.
Imagine another Wayne coming in and going, you know what? I agree to disagree. Maybe she should go in the corner instead of the step, or maybe we shouldn't do that at all, or maybe we should spank her. And you have a whole nother opinion to take into consideration because that's the relationship you
have now. I
agree
with that. I agree
that's
that
really tough.
That could, in some situations, that could become fine. But I mean, like, us three do a podcast and we work on a 2-to-1 rule. It's just like,
we barely work together most of the time and we're not taking care of children.
I don't know. I think we could. All right, let's do it then. Who's.
We've already got the kids there. We just Aunt brings them over.
Us three.
When do I get my time with Jarvis and Lola Mae?
Well, no. I'm thinking about us adopting a little black kid.
No.
That's free.
Can we change the color? I don't really like the black.
Whoa!
Whoa! Hang on.
Where did that come from again?
He's racist, Wayne, isn't he? He is a closet racist. We know
not
that.
Fucking
he's from
closet,
fucking.
He's full out and proud.
I was about to say, why am I closeted?
He's from fucking Atlanta. They wear like bed sheets around there.
We do like bed sheets around here. It's where the KKK is for, son.
Who would be the daddy? Who would be daddy out of us three? I think I know.
Who? You?
Of course he is.
Imagine that. So, and so
who would
the dad,
you think would be daddy? You'd think it'd be me as well, wouldn't you?
No, me.
You reckon it's you?
I am a strict. I was raised by a military father. I am strict when it comes to my nephews and nieces.
But me and Wayne could team up and walk all over you.
Wayne is the mom.
Wayne is definite mom.
Definitely mom.
Is that 100%
mom.
It's because you have breasts, and it's because you're just not going to care. You'd be like, oh yeah, you can do that. Yeah, that's fine. Play with that. That's fine. I don't care.
You're the mom.
So
that makes me the kooky middle cool one.
Absolutely.
That makes me the police academy one.
Yep.
Oh yeah, I'm down with that. Yeah, you'd be fucking Tom Selleck with that bullshit.
Oh, I'm gonna be the mean one. I can guarantee it. I can already guarantee I'm gonna be the mean one. I was raised like that. I'm gonna be the mean
one.
Does
that mean I'm Ted Danson?
No.
Fuck yeah.
Aunt Ted Dancing. Aunt Ted Danson. I mean, Ted Danson. I'm Ted Danson.
Why the fuck are you Ted Danson?
I'm the strict one. Ted Danson was the strict one.
No, he weren't. That's Tom Selleck, you prick.
Oh yeah. That's
right. You've got the bad tash.
They look the same. I don't give a fuck. Let's get the fuck out of here. Jesus Christ. What the fuck are we talking about? Oh my God. He knows that movie.
I am so watching those movies.
He knows that movie like the back of his hand, man. He knows that movie better than he knows his wife's cunt.
Don't don't watch many films, but when I watch a film, I get obsessed. Hence, Rocky, Saw, and Three Men and a Baby.
He doesn't know much, kids,
can't
but he
can't get three more different movies.
I'm telling
Rocky,
you.
Rocky, Saw, Three Men and a Baby.
A drama, a horror movie, and a comedy. Well, at least he's hitting all three.
Yeah, fuck it.
You're in different moods, aren't you?
And what do we... And what have we learned this week?
Holy fuck. I've learned so much this week. I've learned so much that my brain can't compute. But I do want to thank everyone for listening to... If you've listened from fucking show 1 to 50,
I'm impressed.
Just text me and I will send you a mini cock made out of chocolate.
A big thank you.
Because that's just crazy. And thank you for all the new listeners that we've got on this new network. And it's just brilliant. And we're going to change it up and we're going to take over the world.
We're going to try. We're going to do our best. It's going to be good. It's going to be good to go to a new network, right? By ourselves?
By ourselves on our own. Even though we was by ourselves before. Mm-hmm. But we're going to be more recognizable now.
Yep. Absolutely. Wayne, what'd you learn this week?
I really want to rewatch Three Men and a Baby.
Oh shit.
Honestly.
I don't even know if the thing's on
Andy,
Netflix.
You about this week? Do you want to come over and watch it?
Oh my god.
I'd love to, mate. I'd love to.
Dude, he's got an infant. He's not about at any time.
Oh, I'm up for that, mate.
All right. If you,
you
guys
make
do
time
that.
For Ted Danson, you motherfucker.
If you guys do that, you guys have to record it and upload it to the website.
The website.
The website, which is what, Ant?
Fucking Ali G.
What is it? What's the website, Ant?
www.cerebralsatire.com.
Wayne, what's the Twitter? We got Twitter. What's a Twitter, man?
At Cerebral Satire.
And the Facebook is facebook.com/cerebralsatire. I learned that Wayne can be a complete cunt when it comes to his marriage because he doesn't like anybody talking about it.
What?
I'll tell you what I did learn.
What? What?
That you don't like shoes.
Thank you, everybody.
Shoes,
have a great week. By the way,
I want them coming off your souls.
Last thing I'm going to say.
He ain't got no soul. He don't believe in souls.
He's got soul, but he's not.
I'm trying to say something nice, and they just want to dog on me. That's typical. English cunts.
Don't cut it off like you're fucking what? Stalin, you prick.
I do it.
We've got. I do it. We got a Halloween special next week.
Yes.
So by the time you're listening to this, we've probably recorded
it.
But we might not have. There might be a thing where we've got a couple of hours left. So please get your stories in really quickly. As soon as you listen to this. If you listen to us on Friday, get your stories in immediately as you hear me now. Your scary bullshit stories. And then we can cover them this week for Halloween special.
Yep. If you're following us on Twitter, all of us are probably going to tweet it out soon. So please follow us as Devil Vamp on Twitter, Wayne is a Baker on Twitter, MC Vigilante on Twitter. Follow us, Cerebral Satire on Twitter. Guys, follow us. We request you for a reason. We want to hear your stories. We want to hear what's going on. But haunted stories is what we tell every single year. Oh, we do this episode. It's a great episode we do. Everyone likes it.
We do it every year. Wayne.
What?
We do it every single year.
Every single year.
Every single year.
Every single year. This is only the second year. All right,
what
guys.
You said, you fool.
Ant, happy anniversary, buddy.
You too. All right. My little gorgeous girl.
There we go. Bye, guys. Have a great week, everybody.
Hey, Wayne's part of the show as well, mate.
Well, he wasn't here for the first episode.
Yeah, but he's still a part of the show.
Don't worry.
You and your girlfriend.
You two make out on the sofa.
You and your girlfriend can go off somewhere then. Happy anniversary, you fucking cunt. Oh, but the tokens are in my efforts.
Do you think that I'm some kind of dummy?
Think I'm some kind of dummy?
It's the ideal way to
to order the world. Fuck the morals. Does it make any money? And if you don't like it, then leave. Or use your right to protest down the streets. Yeah, use your right, but don't imagine that it's hurt.
He was in Stowe a couple of months ago.
Thanks for listening, everybody.